Dum 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 dum. I need some drum rolls here. Ah, whatever. Welcome to episode 19. Last week, you all were expecting a speech delivered by the Grandmaster in one of the market squares about the great changes that the guild will undergo in the future, and the guild actually told the people that there's a big evil taint heading their way. It's going to take quite a while to get there. And that some brave adventurers found out all about that while traveling the Isles of the Sea. But this little meeting in the middle of the market square was interrupted suddenly when about 20 gnolls emerged from the sewers on all corners of the market square and killed 102 civilians and 3 out of 4 guards. Yeah. So about 50% of all the civilians currently at that marketplace were slain. You managed to fight off. I calculated them. I counted them single-handedly. It was a slaughter. So you managed to drive them off. Orkt did some really cool thing there. He used his scare mechanics. I think he just shouted at one of those gnolls who ran off and sounded the retreat horn, which made them all run off back into the sewers. You managed to capture one gnoll thanks to the help of Tokan, who made him fall asleep. And Tokan also was heavily involved in saving a lot of civilians by using a very small focused tidal wave to topple a lot of gnolls. And after they retreated, help arrived in the form of more soldiers who went to secure the sewer entrances. But yeah, so that was last week. It is still Saturday afternoon. You're still in the market square. Feldril has run off to report to headquarters what happened. And I'm assuming that Orkt stays there with the rest of the people.
Yep.
That's good. So what are you guys gonna do now that there is a lot of broken, weeping civilians and Milo is holding Lady Stephanie, who is weeping into his, leather armor.
Yeah, that's what they call it.
Well, I would start picking up arrows that didn't hit.
I think you did that already.
So all of them.
So you did manage to bind the gnoll so it cannot run off. You disarmed it. Some of the guards are already trying to speak to the gnoll, but it's not really speaking common, so they are having a shout-out match there from, like, speak to us, to rah! So, yeah, that's not a pretty scene, you know.
Do gnolls speak Draconic?
No, they speak gnollish.
They don't speak Draconic. We've already
They speak their own language.
Because Doc asked, do you speak, what languages do you speak? And I went, I speak Draconic, and then Doc was like, no, you don't know it then.
Do you speak Abyssal?
No.
Ah.
No, I speak Common, Infernal, Elvish, and
Draconic. Ah, what a shame.
I speak Common, Elvish, Halfling, and Draconic.
So the Grandmaster comes to the lot of you after sending off Feldril to, you know, report. And he looks at you, Ymir, and he's going like, well, by any chance, you don't have any Hunter's Mark on one of those beasts, did you?
Sadly, I do.
Certainly you do. So where did they went to?
Down the sewers. I don't really feel like going back there. If we have to.
The problem is, if we let them run off too far, we might have a hard time catching them, and they could pop up anywhere else in the city.
Well, kind of frown and looks at Ymir and goes, What happened in the sewer? Sorry, what do you mean go back there?
Well, basically, the sewers smell horrible. I drew a grappling hook at Milo's head.
Okay.
We found a small nest over there with some weird Yeah, humanoid spider-like freaks. It's disgusting. Humanoid
spider-like freaks. How very...
So now like of you. We have fish people and we have spider people.
The Grandmaster looks at all of you, spider people, and you didn't report that?
Well, I was trying to report it, but no one was there.
That was last week. Yes, it was last week. It was last week. Yeah, that's right, we were all in conference. You should have left a note.
I left an egg, but yeah.
This is true, he did leave an egg.
It was broken, so nothing could have hatched from it.
Oh, good to know who was the prankster behind that one.
Wasn't no prank.
Oh,
it wasn't really a prank, I had to get rid of that thing somehow. It's not horrible.
If we could move on, gentlemen, please. Obviously there's a threat in the sewers, Grandmaster. Unfortunately, it seems Milo and I are still bound to you for the moment. I presume you're going to want to go into the sewers and deal with whatever it is that's sent these gnolls. And, might I add, we may have... you should probably ask the guards to start investigating the fires that were set, because those weren't set by any gnoll, which it makes it highly likely they have some form of accomplice who's assisting them in the... And Tokan kind of looks behind him. Butchery that happened here.
Might I also suggest manning every pothole in the city, every sewer entrance?
That would be too many. To man.
Then focus on finding their accomplices, and we'll go down to the sewers.
I'll come with you to the sewers. He looks around. Well, you all look a bit wounded. I would say we take 15 minutes of a break, and then we rush after them. 10 minutes if we could hurry it along, but 15 might be just enough for myself to get ready.
Right. So I presume we're taking a long rest then, Doc?
A short rest.
Sorry, a short rest. Great, I'll use Arcane Recovery to recover one level 3 spell slot.
Oh my god!
Wow! That hit die!
Yes, you may use your hit dies.
Oh my gosh.
I don't even know what my current HP is. Oh, 12. There we go. Sheet, for having my hit die update. What is your hit die? What is my hit die? 1d6 plus 1. Smooth.
And while you're all trying to recover your hit points, I'm sure that Orc is going to give you a Song of Rest.
Yeah, what does Song of Rest do?
Gives you 1d6 extra HP.
Then hold it. Rolling 2d6. So I might not have... I guess, hold on.
It's just a 1d... Yeah, it's just 1d6 extra. If he does...
Okay, so I wouldn't have used the last one.
I already got full health with 1.
Meanwhile, while you're resting, you notice that the Grandmaster is shouting some orders at some soldiers, and within like 5 minutes or something like that, they're bringing him a pretty good-looking piece of plate mail armor and a shield. And a couple of those other soldiers coming to you with a chest. Well, not a chest, with a crate, and they just deposit that in front of you and tell you, well, Grandmaster told us you might need some of those. And then they just head off.
Ah. And Milo flips over the
lid. I poke the crate with one of my arrows to see if it's not a mimic.
It is not a mimic.
Milo just flips it open.
Within it, you find 9 healing potions. But upon close investigation, you notice that they are greater healing potions.
Right.
Yes!
I'll take 3 of them before anyone else can take any.
So that leaves 6.
Milo hands out 2 to Ymir, 2 to Ogd, and 1 to the Grandmaster, and then he keeps 1 for himself.
Okay. They give you 4d4 plus 4, just so you know.
What?
Greater healing.
Like instant full heal.
4d4 plus 4. Sorry?
How much does each one weigh?
The same as a regular healing potion.
Oh,
half.
Wow. Really?
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
They're only a lot more potent.
Yeah.
Yep.
Cool.
Greater healing. So 4d4 plus 4. That's pretty decent.
Yeah, that's pretty decent.
So, Milo 1.
I'm just testing.
Self-diamond 1. Toka 3.
Oh, that's
three.
Not bad, even with the... That's like the shittiest roll I could have gotten, and that's actually like pretty decent. That would have been really good.
Ok, 2. I'm missing somebody. Oh, yeah, Mio. Yeah, that's fine. That should...
Wasn't that bad. So the lowest you can get with these potions is 8.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's really good.
Yeah, it could give you 8. As a minimum. That's true.
There's still more than a normal potion of healing.
Yeah.
Mm. Definitely.
I forgot what my character's bonds and flaws were. I just read them and went, oh yeah.
You may want to go over them again if you need them right now. Just...
Well, my
apparently,
flaw is
I'm guilty of a terrible crime.
Is worth the price of a civilization, which admittedly, right now, might be quite appropriate.
And apparently, I'm guilty of a terrible crime. Hope that I can redeem myself for it, and I have to tell the reviews when I'm lying.
Doc, while we're standing around now, can Milo make a perception to see if he notices any shady people? Particularly anyone that he might notice has that little rat tattoo.
Well, that would be a great perception roll. Yeah, please give me one. I mean, you're all taking like a 15-minute rest. You still have more than 10 minutes. Oh, a bit less than 10 minutes, actually.
Nice.
Indeed, amongst all the survivors, weeping, walking, talking, you notice two people that walk against the flow, and they look around hesitantly, more carefully. They're like, they're looking for something.
I approach them while signing it with the thieves can't symbol, just saying follow. And I start walking for an alley.
They look around, and one of them follows you. The other one is going to stay in the market, keeping an eye on the alleyway that you and the one guy disappear into.
Oh,
okay. At this point, when we're kind of out of earshot of like anyone that might even be close to the mouth of the alley, I just say, "Do you know who did this?"
Yeah, some nasty big monsters did that.
You know what I mean. Those monsters didn't light the fires.
Well, neither did we. We are rats, but we are keeping away from fire.
Didn't accuse you, but is there someone else I should know about that's in the city?
Well, make a persuasion check.
Persuasion?
Uh-huh. He looks at you and he notices that you have neither a fox nor a rat tattooed on your wrist. Well, why would you care about that?
Because I nearly died to these creatures, or I could have died, and I'd like to know who I should be thanking for this unpleasant experience.
Well, I don't know. But if you happen to find some people down there that may have gone missing, and if they do have red tattoos, don't hesitate to set them free.
I'll keep that in mind. I noticed you and your friend over there looking for something. Mind sharing with what you were looking for? Maybe I can help.
We're looking for who did this. And for our friends.
You mentioned foxes. Could they be involved?
Not with those things. I doubt that. I highly doubt that.
Then I have another question for you. I was down in the sewers earlier today, and I came upon...
That was 7 days ago, almost.
Oh,
6 days
well,
ago.
Well, I'll say a week ago, I was in the sewers and came upon a little alcove in the sewers, and it looked like these kind of like spider-like people were being held in cages down there. Would you know anything about any of that?
Nope. And he looks around, like, nope, don't know anything about that.
Mm-mm. Oh, surely someone as intelligent as you would know something.
Do you want to roll inside?
Oh, definitely.
Well, you cannot really point your finger at him and tell him, like, yeah, you're lying, but you do have the impression that he's not really honest about that.
What's wrong? Fox got your tongue? Can't tell me anything?
Yep, must go now. Good luck, and as I said, if you find some of our friends, don't hesitate setting them free. And he turns around, walks out, well, tries to walk out the alleyway, depending on if you want to stab him, stop him, or whatever.
Stab him? That's a bit extreme.
I don't know about this road nowadays.
As he's walking away, I'll just say something about, rats seem to be a little skittish today.
It's the best way to stay alive. And he rejoins with his friend, and they just try making best possible speed out of the market without catching too much more attention. Right.
Well, it just goes and rejoins the group.
Yeah, so your short rest is almost up. And you hear rather than see the Grandmaster approach. It's like some clang, 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 some heavy armor is moving towards you, and he looks quite awkward in that thing. I mean, you haven't seen him in that ever. You've only seen him in like his regular breastplate and whatnot, but this is so unusual for him, having like a full plate armor and a shield in his hand.
Well, I guess if no one else is going to say anything. I guess Ogden said, shall we, so.
Good. So.
Yeah, of course, we'll do it. Yamir, who has to lead us.
Yamir, your guy went into that sewer back way when. The northern exit.
Now I'm just take point.
Mm-hmm. You take point.
Milo will follow up right behind him. And as we're about to go in, Milo will put on his goggles.
Ooh. Yeah, and I'll whisper for my wolf to follow as well before it gets left behind.
Okay. Mage armor still active, by the way, Doc.
Yeah, sure. It should still be that. I mean, it's 8 hours, isn't it?
Yeah, okay. And it's not concentration, so.
No, it's not. So we've got, what's his name? Yamir first. Okay, who's next?
Milo.
Tokan will bring up the rear.
I just need to give Milo his sight now. That's a regular 60, right?
Yeah, 60 feet.
Okay.
Very useful.
Yeah.
I hope so. So next one is Tokan?
Yep.
Let's see if your light is okay. You have sight. Everything should work out once I swap you over. Who's next then? Oct, I guess.
I suppose, yeah.
It's kind of like the almost last guy. And then we've got... Uh-oh. Wait, did I ever say that he's just human? I think he's just human.
He'll probably take a torch from some of the guards. I mean, he probably has a flashlight.
Yeah, he'll probably hold the torch behind the shield so he has at least some light without giving away his position.
It's like a 40-20. That's a pretty good idea. I would do that myself if I could.
Warrior perks. Have a torch behind your shield. Torch is concealed and you have light.
Yeah, blinding you. Actually, you know what? Yeah, I should consider that. Emits light. Oh gosh, 270 degrees. So it's kind of like shining behind him. So let's turn on the dynamic light. Check that everything's good. And it's exactly the wrong place around that the light is shining for him. Negative 2670. Okay, there's no negative value for him. That's dumb. I give him a reduced lamp. Right, welcome to the sewers, everyone.
Oh, we're all the way there in the blackness.
Yeah, all the way here in the blackness.
Let's see, where did the prey come?
Oh yeah, sorry about that. You feel that your hunter's mark is somewhere in that direction. I hope you saw that ping, so it's kind of like there.
Why did I?
Why am I purple? I hate purple.
It's more of a pink. Token's purple.
Yeah, I don't know
what the hell color I am. So there we go. That one should be better now. It's like, yeah, so, that's a good color.
The Grandmaster, he's carrying a torch or what?
Yeah, he has like a lamp thingy attached to his shield. He sadly is just a human.
Can we listen and see if we hear anything?
Sure! And he's gonna try listening as well. He's gonna be on your side now. Perception.
Oh, fucking hell. If that had been one lower, I could have at least rerolled.
Where is...
Oh, well, the group is kind of fake. Oh, the wolf! I'm sorry, I forgot the wolf. You're wolfy. You could roll for your wolf if you want to. Because yeah, it has ears as well.
I was waiting for the model. Let's see, where's the button? There's bite. There's only bite. Where's...
Don't you have an extra... You should have an extra...
Yeah, but I'm trying to find it.
It's in your journal. Yeah, under... Perception. Players. no, nee, that would be a 21. No, that's a 21, but there's something wrong with this sheet. Did you fiddle with that by any chance?
Nope. It's because it has a plus 3.
I know, I saw that.
It has 2 pluses, so it doesn't work.
It's exactly as you gave me.
Yeah, I forgot that. Because you use the sheet, you use it differently than I. Let's see if this works now. Okay, so he rolled a 21 earlier. Your wolf definitely is nervous about something. He hears that there are things nearby. For the rest of you, all you hear is just the water dripping and running and maybe some rats in the distance.
What's the thing? What do you hear?
It whines to you. You're like, yeah, please. It's not that loud.
Come on, boy. Lead us to the target.
It looks around. It looks like this way, and it looks the other way, and it looks down that way, and it's like giving you the impression, like, what target do you mean? That's like every direction.
Moles. You know, there's many things.
Well, now you say moles, it looks up there and it looks to there, and you have the impression from your hunter's mark that it is this way to your desired destination.
Okay, guys, let's go. Look on, I'll take point so you don't get ambushed.
I'll point at the Grandmaster. Shouldn't he take point in his massive plate armor?
Well, he tanks like kitchen. They'll sense him coming.
They're going to sense him coming regardless.
Well, better we get in position before he clanks his way to them.
Let's see, he says that he is relatively silent, but he rolled a 4. So he's gonna be like, the first step he does like...
Milo immediately turns to him. Like, you're gonna have to be more quiet.
Okay, so he waits for you guys to go up. You all are stealthed?
I am.
Because if so, please write your stealth numbers in the blue bubble. So that I can check you against the passive perception of all those...
Well, my wolf is cloaked.
Neat little things.
Can Milo, like, tell...
It's too late! It's too late. Everyone freeze. It's like... Orc gave you away. Please, roll your initiative. Now.
Oh, piss. Oh, fuck off.
Orc just clambered around the corner and he's being seen by 5 gnolls easily. Let's put them up there. Oh, well, that didn't really help for that dude. Descending. Orc, are you shouting anything while you're already being watched by the gnolls?
He'll just point, like...
Okay, well then, the,
guys, the dwarf has found them.
Sel'Darin is like, oh, make place there for me! I'm trying to get to him! he gets by Milo and Tokan, so that was like his first 30 feet.
Step aside. Kitchen is coming through.
So, yeah, he gets himself on there. Kind of like gets himself on point. But that was all his actions he could do.
Now my ears are ringing.
Milo's gonna like peer around the corner really quick, but not show himself.
Are you trying to ride my wolf?
Milo, you do see that there is one standing up there, right?
Yeah, I see him, and then I see one there, over here.
Oh yeah, sorry, I totally forgot about this. Yeah, there's another sentry over there. Mm-hmm.
That stupid torch, Jesus.
What stupid torch?
Or lamp, whatever. Milo's gonna use the rest of his movement to try and get behind this pillar so he's not seen still.
Okay. You're still stealthy, right? Yeah. You're fine. They don't see you.
Yeah, so he's just gonna stay right here for now.
Mm-hmm. That's it?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, Oct. The one.
I mean, besides him having two deckers, I don't know.
The one that saw the gnolls and the one that has been seen by the gnolls. Your stealth is... On.
They had like horns or something for other spec at the top.
Yeah, they had one guy with a horn.
Which one is it?
You ask questions. It's oh gosh, I believe that's.
Gosh,
I think it's that one. I don't know. They all look the same to me.
That's right.
But this one is the least one damaged. That was from the close quarter combat side.
So I'm sure it's him. I'm just gonna cast silence like there, I suppose.
Okay.
There, so it gets the whole room or the whole area here. So they can at least do an alert, and then he'll just he'll move next to the Grandmaster.
So, how much feet is that silence thing?
I'll link it. Second.
I'd appreciate if you post the 20-foot radius. So, where was the center?
Somewhere there. It doesn't. It hits everyone from there, right? Yeah.
Let's see if that is the. Oh, yeah. Kind of that, yeah. What does it do? Duration, no sound can be created within or passed through. That's fine. Yeah, that's fine.
So Salary can clank all around the place.
Yeah, but you're not there yet. Right, that's a turn, yes?
Yeah, he's not gonna step on the board, so yeah, that's his turn.
Just a second, wife is back.
Is the woman here?
Token, you don't have Fireball, do you?
Fuck off.
Fireball is a warlock spell, Milo.
Oh shit, it is.
Yeah, yeah.
All he has is Fireball. I'm not sure if he waits until level 30 for Meteor.
As far as I'm aware.
Sorry, Beck. Okay, what is Yamia doing?
I'm gonna walk over to this other pillar, so I'm more concealed.
Uh-huh.
Seeing as my wolf has 23 stealth, I'm gonna try to move him a bit closer.
Yeah, the wolf is gonna stay stealthy, but your 10 is nothing against their passive perception, and now they're looking out for you guys, so... Your stealth is basically gone.
Also, Fireball is Sorcerer and Wizard, not Warlock.
Huh. Yeah.
Gonna change.
No.
But I'm gonna hold my attack until one of them comes...
Which one?
Me. I'm holding an arrow until one of them hit this area.
Ah, okay. Something like that. Mm-hmm.
And my wolf's gonna hold his attack until something gets on where Southern Orc is standing.
Right, so we've got the gnolls. The outer sentries, of course, hearing this clank, 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 armor coming up from two people. The little dwarf and the huge human. So they're going to shoot the human first. So three arrows for the human. If I can find them. 1, 2, 3. First misses. Second hits. Third hits. So Seldarin gets hit by... two arrows, but the armor takes most of the damage away from him, so it's like some little puncture wounds. And the others are now getting up. Let's see. Choop, choop, choop. That guy runs right at Seldarin. Oh, yeah, he gets shot at. Okay, shoot!
Yep.
Shoot! Hits. Takes 5 points of damage. The other one is rushing up. Yeah, I mean, they're gonna be stupid enough. They're all gonna run onto the board.
So that one doesn't get shot at.
So... Is he gonna jump into the water? Yeah, he's gonna jump there as well. Okay. So they're running out. There's one more archer here. I don't think he can see you. I doubt that. Oh! Actually, he can. Another arrow for the clanky tank. If I find him. Longbow. That one misses. So you see one more arrow flying like from that direction, but hitting nothing. And that's their turn. Tokan. Clank Clank Warzone.
Is it my turn?
Yeah, it's your turn, Tokan.
Oh, charming.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, I do have... Yeah, fuck it. Tidal Wave.
There's still the Grandmaster in the way.
I can choose to start at that point, Doc. It doesn't
have
to
come from me. Oh, can you? Okay.
I can start summoning it there. So, yeah. I'll roll Tidal Wave.
Open the floodgate!
Right.
Tokan brings his hand up.
That's a deck save, isn't it?
4d8 if they fail, deck save, 2d8 if they don't.
This one too,
hang on. I'll roll my damage first, Doc, yeah?
Yeah, roll your damage first, so I need to...
15 damage if they fail the deck save, and it's against my spell save, which is 15. So they have to beat 15 on a deck save.
Okay.
And they go prone, right, if they fail?
If they fail, they fall prone as well.
Yeah. The one... Do you make it like a 15-feet pipe so it hits as well?
No, I think he goes straight, right? How wide do you make it?
Yeah, but I can have it 20-foot wide, so yeah, I can do that, and then that.
Kind of like that.
Yeah, you literally, basically, Doc, it rises from the water underneath them. And
that's
just a
that's perfect.
Destroys them.
That is perfect. So they afterwards they are not poison. What do you say they were?
Prone. Not prone.
Prone.
Prone. There we go. So the first one, prone.
Yep.
save, Dex. It was stupid of them to go all onto it.
Well, they didn't see me.
The one in the middle, he's like being washed away. It goes up to the very end of the cavern, right?
Yeah.
So you see him getting washed against there, and he drowned.
Oh, cool. Well, okay, fair
enough. More or less.
Oh, you can transfer your Hunter's Mark, can't you, next turn for free.
Save, Dex. Nice.
Thanks for that.
Yeah.
This one, the second one after is like the same. So both of them get washed up against the wall, if that is what you desired.
Yeah,
and the archer of the plateau?
Yeah, let's see what the archer does.
So the first guy saved it?
The first guy failed, but he didn't fail that badly.
I can't see if he's got a little...
The archer, he succeeded, so he only takes half your damage.
Seven.
And he's, you know, he's like getting wet feet and whatnot because he's up there. He's like, argh! Okay. Well, you killed two gnolls.
Yeah,
one is prone and the other one is a bit shaken, a little bit washed, cleaner, better smelling.
Advantage on that one that's knocked down.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Sadron was wearing his sword, so.
So that's your turn, right? You stay there. Right. Seldarin looking at the guy, the gnoll in front of him, he like takes his dragon short sword and he attacks the gnoll twice. So sword comes down, boom, right into his shoulder, and then
that's awesome.
Good that he has advantage because he rolled 5 and 5 each on the attack, but the advantage ones were like 21 and 20. And then the second one, he swings again and he just lands the sword right in the neck of the gnoll and just like dies, topples over and lands in the water.
Great. Water poisoning.
This is sewage water, remember. We don't want
that
to
is
drink in
the sewage thing. Water, yes. Yeah. That one is pretty iffy. He clanks up front. He goes into close combat with the actually, sorry about that. No, he goes to the left side, right side. So he's going to block off this archer.
Nice.
That's his turn.
Guys, when we reach level, when a wizard reaches level 20, he gets to choose third level spells as his signature spells. I think Tidal Wave might be one of Tokan's.
Right, Milo, what's your turn?
High utility completely fucks over everything.
Milo's going to. Oop, hold on.
That's not a good way to go AFK, but okay.
Alright, so Milo's running forward. And I'm assuming I'm still stealth. So I'm running up to this guy. He's not like way above me, he's just like right there, right?
You're running stealthed over a wooden plank. He has dark vision. I understand you staying stealthed if you are on corners, behind pillars, or even running in that trench maybe, bushes, but running in the open, I doubt that would really be stealthy.
I mean, my idea was is that he's preoccupied with the others, but if not, oh well.
You're crossing open ground, you're not invisible, you're just stealthed.
Oh well, then I'm stabbing at this guy regardless.
Okay, sure. You may do so.
Oh, halfling luck, hold on.
Run. 1, 1, 1, 1. Oh, bloody. Yeah, that one hits. So he takes 2 points of damage?
Yeah. Well, he takes 8.
But he would take your sneak attack damage total. Too, right? Because. Oh, no, he wouldn't.
I'd have to have advantage,
true.
Or else.
True. There's nobody around and you are not stealthed at that point.
Yeah.
Okay. That was your action. Any bonus action?
Well, that was my bonus action too. The second attack was.
Oh, sorry. I only saw the second attack. So you dealt another 8 points up there. Okay. Yeah, so you sneak up and fleetfully run over, have your daggers, and you poke him in his legs. And he's like, ah! You think that he's going to be almost down. He's still up there, but it's not much to kill him.
Is this another one?
No, it's not. No. From your perspective, okay. He's almost down, but he's...
Alright.
It's a bit more than one HP.
Alright, and then that's it.
Okay. I would say Tokan roll me perception, but he ain't there.
I am.
Oh, then please roll me perception out of turn.
Oh,
sure.
That's not good.
That's why I said it's not a good place to go AFK where you are.
15.
That's fine.
Yeah, I see them.
Yeah, they're not going to be... Oops, sorry. Springing the surprise on you. Because you see them come sneaking around the corner.
Oh, these are cultists, then.
Let's roll the initiative and hope they are going to be running after you guys.
Oh, they cooked me! Yes!
That's fine.
A fanatic, not so much.
Yeah.
See, they don't enter till the next turn. Or
yeah, they're going to be... Cult Fanatic is going to be coming before Sildarin and after you, Tokan. And the cultists are going to be waiting way longer. Anyhow, so it's Ox's turn. You see them, but... Yeah. Oct.
Well, seeing as the fridge has a cover on, he's going to move over.
Oct, you're really quiet.
Yeah, he is really, really quiet.
Yeah, you need to maybe move your mic closer.
Well, looks like he's running forward, like a hero that he is.
It was with a disadvantage though, but he's probably not going to hit anyone.
Yeah, why did you roll disadvantage?
I just forgot to turn it off.
Yeah, well, the 13 does not hit. You come running with your Slayer's Axe and thinking, yay, that's going to be a big giant, and he's like, nope, misses.
Yeah, let's turn then.
Okay, Ymir?
I'm gonna move a bit forward.
Okay.
Is there anything on the left that I can see?
On the left? Well, yeah, there's this one knoll. Yeah. That one, sure, you see him.
And then I reapply my Hunter's Mark on it.
Yes.
Just like I murdered the last one I've had it.
Yes, bonus action, transfer Hunter's Mark, yep.
I'm gonna sharpshoot it. Twice.
Yes, there's no civilians over there.
Hits, misses. So it does take an arrow right into his stomach. He's writhing in pain, but his eyes just like flaring up, kind of like.
Yeah, Hunter's Mark damage.
Oh, that yeah, roll for Hunter's Mark 6.
Whoa.
He is even more in pain. He's gonna get his revenge. He's still standing. What? Almost wanting to touch his stomach. Sorry?
I'm gonna send the wolf up to Milo and Doc.
Okay. Wolf is no longer hidden because it's now crossing open terrain.
Yep. I'm fine with that.
And that's
next.
It. Yep. Right, so the one that was just shot by you, that's the one logical thing. It steps behind the pillow, the pillar. And it shoots back at you.
Silly Noel, Ymir's a sharpshooter. Cover doesn't work against sharpshooters.
It doesn't know that.
No,
it's
know.
A silly one.
It's
arrow. Really forceful arrow. Boom! Zooms by your ear and explodes behind you against the wall. You have the feeling if that would have hit you, it would have hit you really good, but it misses. The Noel...
I smile.
Yeah, the Noel... Let's see, where else? The one null, very far away, shoots at the Grandmaster, unless it can see you. No, you're too far away. So it shoots at the Grandmaster with a bow.
Which null?
There's one very far away.
Oh,
they can currently only see the Grandmaster.
It's over here, then.
That's a bit higher than that. Yeah, nope, misses. That plate armor, though. Bing! Arrow deflected. And the one in front, he closes with the Grandmaster, and he is gonna claw at him. Because he drops his bow. He's like, yeah, bow, no good that close quarter. So, brings out his claw. And some horrible screech noises go through the caverns, like, but that, nope, nope. It's no damage on him. That armor is holding armor tough. Fuck. Yeah, that armor is really good. Arc, the gnoll in front of you, being inspired by the screechiness, he's gonna lean down and try bite you, but he misses.
Oh, is the silence gone, by the way?
Nope.
True, oh, well, he doesn't hear that, so he's not being inspired by that. they just think there was some screech noise. Anyways, he misses you. And that really is...
That silence being gone.
And that is that for the gnolls.
Cool.
Don't go on.
Yeah, I'm just checking a range quickly. 60 foot, cool. I'm going to cast Ice Knife at the fanatic.
Mm-hmm.
So... but I'm casting it as a level 2 spell slot.
Mm-hmm.
So it deals... more ice, it deals more damage if it hits. Anyway, I'll roll the hit first. Let's see if Ice Knife works. Who wants to bet it doesn't?
I'm neutral on that.
Yes!
Hey!
It hits.
Nice, cool. So that deals 5 piercing damage to him, and then the cold damage, hang on, that only rolled...
That's a dex save.
It rolls an extra d6, so another d6.
What's a dex save?
It's against my spell slave.
Yeah, but why is it there? So he has a dex save.
Because the ones... So, hang on. Plus another 3, so 12 frost damage if they fail the dex save. It explodes when it hits him. Him
okay.
And any creature in 5 foot has to take a dex save. If they fail it, they take 12 frost damage.
So how much does he take regularly? 5?
He takes 5 piercing damage
okay.
No matter what.
He got
if
that.
If that hits, if 18 is a hit, I presume
it hits.
A hit.
Yeah.
So he takes 5, and then everyone rolls a dex save.
Everyone besides him.
Him included.
Okay.
He still takes the frost damage, Doc. It explodes on him. So.
Well, the one cultist fails. The other one.
Do they take no damage if they succeed or half?
I think half.
I believe so.
It's no damage. I think.
Or take 2d6 cold damage.
I would say half, because most saves allow you to...
No, I think it is. It's just, they take no damage, because they just dodge the shards.
Oh, okay.
Like, it's like a grenade going off, basically.
So then only the one in front of him gets really damaged, and he needs to roll as well.
Does Tokran also like shout incoming from the back or something?
He's going to.
Nah, he failed.
Oh, nice. The fanatic failed?
Uh-huh.
Oh, sweet.
Perfect.
Cool. And then Tokran says, hostiles behind. And... He's gonna run the fuck away from them. And leave it to someone with armor to take those hits. He's running there.
I mean, technically, you have armor. It's called mage armor.
Yeah, 14. Woo!
Well, I'm concealed by the pillar, so I'm technically safe.
Yeah. Well, anyway, and he sprints away.
Okay, that's you sprint away.
Well, not sprint, but.
Yeah. And I know what you mean.
Vaguely waddle away.
Okay, so he did his move.
Yep. Wow, they don't have very much movement, huh? I should have just used Ray of Frost. It just reduced his movement even more.
Oh, you just don't know where he went. That's all.
Uh huh.
Those are not stupid-minded people. Anyway, Sildarin attacks the thing in front of him. First attack misses. Second attack deals 11 points of damage. You see some flames dancing over the body armor of that gnoll. And that's his turn, Milo.
Alright, we're just going to go dagger against this one.
Now this time there should be some bonus,
sneak
right?
Sneak attack.
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh!
So I deal 20...
Yeah, that's enough. How do you want to do this?
Oh, I just stab him in the guts and eviscerate his... intestines.
Okay, and all that fluid flows down and boop, 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 down the stairs. Colors, Orc's shoes, red.
Alright, and then I'm just gonna kind of run over here and get behind this pillar after hearing Tokan say something about enemies from behind.
Mm-hmm.
I know I'm not technically hidden, but yeah.
Okay. Cultists. Oh, they are so angry.
Wait, why are they going? They're at a 2. They should not go until Tokon's turn.
Oh, right. They should be all the way down there now.
Yeah.
Because they rolled really badly.
Really badly.
That's fine. That's fine. That's fine. So, Oct.
Oct will turn around, take a step backwards. You can see that no, right?
Oh yeah, you can see. Well, wait, can you? Yeah, he's covered a bit for you. Yeah, he would be considered at least half cover for you.
Yeah, so I suppose we'll just ignore the guy. He was worried about people coming from behind. He'll just guard this bridge here, and then he'll take a he'll shout at Zedra and duck, and he'll throw a hand axe that way.
Which way? This one? Oh, that one. Yeah, okay, you hit. Expertly throwing it almost in the curve. Almost a curveball. And hitting him right on the shoulder plates. Like, sinking in 5 points of damage being applied.
And that after that, he'll brace and guard this little bridge thingy for right. Anything coming from there.
So the gnoll is still looking at you, Ymir, and he's certain that behind this pillar he's gonna be safe from your arrows.
I simply smile and fire 2 arrows at him.
Right. How you wanna do this?
Wait, did he kill him? What
arrow to the left?
The first shot killed him. The first shot killed him. You just need 1 arrow for that.
Yeah, but I want to plant the other one in the other eye socket just in case.
He's just overkill, okay.
Nice.
He's like, he's like this huge massive thing, just looks around the tiny pillar and just chip chip. And then he just falls back, lands, and lays still. One arrow to each eye.
I'm behind Tokon.
Okay.
And I'm gonna move my wolf towards Milo. Yeah.
Giving Milo a good time there. The gnoll. That one that's with Seldar. Okay. Actually, no, wait. First, the one that's still a long way off shoots.
Well, it's not an action gnoll, so you can do that any time.
Shit. So while Seldar has been holding his own fairly well against the gnolls, out of the blue. And you, Tokon, you don't even hear that because it's still the bubble of silence.
No,
there.
Not.
Is it gone?
Said he dropped it.
Okay, so you hear some VOOM! Vroom, 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 vroom. When you look over to Sildaren, you see that he has suffered a massive wound to his stomach. He took like 18 points of damage. And he just. Yeah, that was just a crit hit.
No.
From the gnoll. The gnoll in front is like. Should I go? Should I stay? And after seeing this massive hit land on the floor in front of him, he's like, "No way! I'm staying!" And he claws him, tries to claw him, but he fails again. Shit, that armor is really tough, man. Tokon.
The guy really has a huge health bar.
Yeah.
I know he has. He's your tank.
Dice. Tokon steps out onto the bridge, flicks his hand up, fires a firebolt at the one fighting the Grandmaster.
Christmas!
18.
Yeah, hits. Could you please roll the damage whenever you roll for hitting so that I know what happens? Thank you. Okay, -8.
Yep.
It just, boom! He goes up in flames. He still stands, but he's almost medium cooked now.
So I'll step back and I'll say, watch the side entrance, Ogd. Over there. As well, just in case, because it looks like that could be another way they could come round.
I got my eyes open.
And that's it. That's all I can do. cultists.
Yeah, don't worry, they do their turn right now.
Sure.
They have done their turn. It's his turn now.
That's it.
Dum 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 dum. Let's see. He's got a lot of spells.
Yeah.
That's good, yeah. Yeah. I know what he's doing. You guys hear from somewhere up there a noises as if there's like a lot of people running or something. Like, you cannot really make it out, but there's definitely some footsteps coming from up there.
From where?
From where?
From... Don't you see where when I'm pinging? From there.
No.
Oh, it was too far away. I've got it zoomed in too far. Oh,
okay, so it's coming from that direction.
Alright.
You hear some footfalls. And let's see... Yep. That's basically that for now. The Grandmaster's turn. Who swings the sword and tries to finish off the foe in front of him and succeeds. He's just like, cut, cut, and then the last cut just slices right through the throat, and it just gurgles and drops into the water. Where it lays, and the water now starts to turn red. Flowing in that direction up there.
It's already red then, isn't it?
Yeah, it's more red now. I mean, the one that you... Yeah, true, there's two in the water now.
Aren't your courses drifting up there as well over time?
Yeah, now the water isn't high enough for that yet.
Oh. Yet? Don't say that. We're gonna get flooded now.
No, I think this is already the one with all the water in it. I don't think there's a flooded version.
Tidal wave.
Mm-hmm. Natural tidal wave against you guys. Okay, Milo, it's your turn.
Fuck.
Alright, I'm gonna be getting over here really quick and use my bonus action to hide.
Mm-hmm. Looking good. Solid 18.
And then I'm just gonna kinda get right here and hold my attack for if something comes around this corner, I'm gonna stab it.
Right, so you're kinda like watching this way.
Yeah, kind of.
Okay. Oct.
Well, he could hear the stuff from coming from this direction, right? But nothing from here.
Even further up. It's like somewhere up there. You don't even know where, but yeah.
Just that particular path, yeah.
Yeah. There's a lot of footsteps.
Well, he's gonna shout. Are you gonna stay here or push in the one of this path? And then he's gonna stay there. And then he is, let's say he'll... he'll just, if he gets like a throw without any cover, he'll throw attacks at ending moves, hostile, from this or that direction, if you can see them.
No, I don't see where you're pointing. Unless I'm too zoomed in. Ah, okay.
This, mm-hmm. He'll try to keep these two paths in his eye, and he'll throw attacks into any of the, if there's something come from
either. It's going to be a feat to do that, but yeah, okay. Ymir?
I'm going to move to the side, crouch, and ready an arrow for anything that comes from this redirection.
So, there's still one null left, and he's like... He saw his friend getting, like, chopped into pieces, and he shoots at the Grandmaster. And he misses, and after that, he's like, I'm out of here. That's no good. So he retreats a bit.
Do we hear it running away?
I can only... Well, I mean, you hear more footsteps from up there, where you were already hearing footsteps. Sounds a bit heavier, though. Like, Noel-ish. But Seldarin sees him. No, he doesn't, because it's dark. Nope, Seldarin doesn't see that. Seldarin hears him running. Okay, Tokon. The one that's almost on the bottom of the list.
Yeah.
That's pretty good because you can clean up whatever the others fail to clean. It's not the worst spot to be. Okay.
And appears around the corners.
Whatever you see is what you see.
I don't see anything. Yeah, and then he steps
there's
back.
Nothing. Okay. And that's that for the... Oh my gosh, he's still there. Yeah. The footsteps are coming closer. At least you hear that they're coming closer. Right, the Grandmaster, he's like, shit, like they can see in the dark and I can't. So he gets himself ready to attack if anything comes in his range and into the light bubble that he's creating. So he's going to stay there. Milo.
Milo's going to head in the direction that he saw Tokon go. He's just going to kind of squeeze past Tokon there. peer out really quick.
Uh-huh. You see a lot of pillars, but you don't see anything behind it.
Milo's going to just motion for Tokon to possibly follow. And it's going to get right behind this pillar here.
Uh-huh. Yeah, you're stepping right next to the knoll with the two arrows in his skull. In his head.
Yeah.
Sticky eyes.
Yeah.
You're still hidden for now because nobody sees you where you are.
Yes, I like being hidden.
Mm-hmm. Oct? Unless, Milo, you want to ready something.
I mean, if something comes, like, within throwing distance of my knives, I'll probably just go dagger.
Okay. I'm guessing up or down, because from where the water flows and the map is ending, there's not anything coming from there.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, Oct, it's your turn. Nobody showed up.
And nobody answered Oct either, so he'll just go, well...
Maybe you were not loud enough. You should shout it as loud as possible so that even the cultists can hear you.
Yeah, exactly. Well, that's too well. The one word echoes through the sewers. And he'll stay here and do the same as last turn.
Okay. Quite exposed on the wooden platform. Right. Ymir.
I'm gonna get the higher ground and keep my attack ready for both entrances now.
Okay, you go wait.
And I'm gonna make my wolf sit on the stairs.
Mm-hmm. So,
yeah. Is there anything that comes in front of me?
So the gnoll is running away, but can he see the... Ooh, he can still see the Grandmaster a bit. Let's just check the range on that. Oh, perfect. Grandmaster's still sitting there in the darkness like, okay, what's going on? I don't have anybody to battle. And the arrow comes zooming right past his ear, like shoo! That doesn't hit him. And I just noticed that the gnoll is pretty dumb.
Oh,
dumb. No, actually, he's not that dumb. There is an exit there. But the gnoll, seeing that he can still hit this one human dude, he's just gonna sit there and wait. I mean, he did his action, but he's gonna hide behind the pillar. Stand behind the pillar. Sorry about that. Tokon.
Yeah. Hang on, sorry. We're gonna step over here.
Uh-huh. You just like take like a long step over to not fall into the water. That's fine.
Steps up.
Mm-hmm.
And I suppose seeing as I can't do all already a spell? Already
yep.
A firebolt, so yep. If anything enters range of firebolt, I'll cast firebolt.
The firebolt was a cantrip, right?
Yep.
Okay, yeah, sure, can do that. My goodness! Oh, that's an old, they're barking! Right, cultist's turn. Cultists do their thing. Cult fanatic, he's doing his thing. And you still hear the footsteps coming closer. I hope you can see the pinging, more or less.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so Darren, he's like, I'm getting shot at all the time, so he's gonna make a local recording. Seems to be picking up again.
You do have that I gave the Grandmaster one of the greater healing.
Yeah, I've written it down. Okay. Oh, you know what? Yeah, that's a good idea. He could just seeing that there's nothing coming immediately, he's gonna pop one of the healing potions. Thanks for reminding me. So
no problem. That's what I'm here for.
He gets +12 out of that. He looks a bit healthier now, and that is his action. So Milo, it's your turn.
All right, Milo is just going to go from pillar to pillar. And get here. Oh, I was expecting an opening.
You were expecting an opening where?
Right
maybe
here.
There's one.
Maybe.
You see that there's at least an alcove or something built into.
Can Milo make a perception check from here, or an investigation to see if he notices any sort of
investigation? Not, but you could do toss me a perception.
All right. This is searching for a secret door, so because of Dungeon Delver, I get advantage on it.
Mm-hmm. Looking into the dark with your goggles. It's almost as if they have a zoom function, which they don't. they also have no infrared or any other options on it, sadly.
Yet, don't. But once we get a tinkerer, Milo will have, like, splinter cell glasses.
Milo, I'm really sorry to disappoint you, but there is no hidden door anywhere on that entire vicinity here. There's no hidden door, nothing.
However, there's a very fine brick.
No, there's not. It's
Milo's just gonna cry in a corner for the rest.
That was a really, really good toss, but there is really, honestly, nothing. I'm so sorry that this had to happen.
Day.
Okay, that's it. Oct.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll just go to scrub back up as well.
Okay.
And just I chill here. I mean, what's the rush? He's just gonna stay here.
I'm gonna hold my position firmly.
True.
I suppose he'll go here so he can throw the axe if something comes from there.
Yamir, toss me an intelligence check, please. Just regular intelligence, not the safe.
Right,
well, then it would have been 18.
Is that the same? Okay, well, it's just still the same. You don't have an extra check mark on that. So we just take the 17. It has been a few seconds that you've been holding up in this little alcove, and your mind casts back to the last group that was inhabiting that particular part of the sewer system, and you're getting an uneasy feeling that if you could just bum rush the gnolls that were there, who says that nobody else can just rush you the same you did with them? So you're having an uneasy feeling being there at that exact point, having a dead gnoll to your feet.
I'm gonna jump down, look a bit upstairs, and I'm readying an arrow just in case.
Okay. That poor gnoll now, he cannot see anybody. Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to move him. Gosh, why did that one happen?
It's okay, Doc. We can see him anyways.
No, I just move him back where he's supposed to be. I wanted to measure the distance from him. He's looking! But he can't find anybody. So he's getting his arrow ready. So the moment anyone steps out here somewhere, he's gonna let loose his arrow. Well, you don't know that, but you've seen a lot of arrows hitting that particular spot earlier, so...
I thought to say, guys, you have meta the shit out.
Yeah, you have kind of like the notion that if the thing that was shooting the arrows is still there, it would be a dangerous spot to be. In the meantime, Seldarin did break off the arrow shaft that was sticking out of his stomach, and... Yeah, well, he used his healing potion earlier. Anyhow, Tokan.
By the way, Milo would have said, Tokan, this is a dead end.
Token, it's not there. Dum, 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 dum.
Token would hold a firebolt.
Yeah, he's holding a firebolt. The cultists do their thing. The cult fanatic does his thing. And you guys clearly hear that the steps should be somewhere here now.
Sorry, why did I get skipped?
Nope, we asked you like four times.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was being messaged by my other half.
Okay.
I do apologize. Literally, I would just do movement and then...
Okay, move where you want to move, and you're holding your firebolt.
And then I'll hold the firebolt, yeah.
Okay.
Sorry, I'm so sorry.
That's fine. Sel'Darren is holding his shield in front of him and getting his sword ready. He's like, I'm hearing some. They should be coming out the corner soon. Okay, that's it, Milo.
Milo dejectedly is going to turn back around.
I'm so sorry.
And then use my bonus action to dash. And I'm just going to get right here.
Okay.
And then hold my action. If one pops up and it's within 20 feet of me, I'm going to throw a dagger at him.
So basically somewhere there.
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay.
Basically where everyone else has gone that
bad. What is Zoc going to do?
That's he's part of the waiting, so he's just going to walk there. Feel free to shoot him.
Wait. arrow comes flying your way, even so you don't know that there is one.
Yeah, but he's pricing with his shield at least. There's at least some hope.
So Orc just steps forward, shield up, and you hear like clang, and the arrow is square stucking into your shield. So you look around the shield for a moment, like, oh, that's a big arrow, and then you have the shield back up in front of you. Okay.
Surprise. He can't see anyone, right? I don't think so.
Out here, you see some movement, something in the shadows.
And he'll take one more step forward.
Right, surprisingly, you don't see anything.
Oh, shit.
You're so sure that there were some footsteps, but there's nobody to be seen.
Shit.
He doesn't turn around, he just backs up there. Turns around and says, no one there. And then that's his turn.
Okay. Ymir?
I'm gonna slightly move forward.
Except for the guy with the arrows.
Except for the guy with the arrows, there's nobody there. when you step around Orkman, he's like, oh, there's nobody there. You see this massive arrow sticking into his shield.
Really, Ox? No one? Where did that come from? Dramatically pointing at the arrow. Let's see.
No source for the sound of steps, at least.
I have no vision on whatever shot the arrow from here.
You do see, well, no, if you step there, you will be able to see some hidden movements, some deep in the shadows, but not where you are currently.
We can't.
Turn off one step forward.
Yeah, you see there in the darkness, there's some massive shadow moving.
Oh, just within range.
Yeah, it is just within range. Give it your best toss.
Here goes nothing.
Yeah, that's about what I expected. Shoo! Arrow goes, and second arrow, shoo! Into the darkness, right where you thought the center mass of this big moving shadow should be. Nothing happens.
It gets stuck in midair.
No, you hear, because it's so far away, it could be something falling somewhere, but maybe it's the arrow hitting the brick wall far, far off.
And I'm going to step back.
Yeah, you're stepping back.
And that concludes my turn.
Okay, that guy does his turn, Token. Gosh, where's the army when you need it?
I'll step up here. I don't think I see the... No.
Well, you see something shadowy moving out there.
Oh, I literally, like, don't actually see that.
I know, but it is some darker shadows in the midst of the shadows.
Sure.
You have 60 feet, right?
Yeah.
And I granted it to see... I mean, seeing Sildarin is easy. He's like this massive light source, but out there, you have the feeling there is something in the shadows.
Great.
I tried shooting it, though, but it didn't work.
Let's light that up.
Sure. See if you hit it.
Good success.
Oh. No. Pshoo! But as the firebolt rushes by, you do see that there is a null archer standing there, who's a bit surprised as the light just goes right by him.
Flashbanged him.
He is being hiding behind a massive pillar.
Mm-hmm. We'll step back if we
can. I can't.
Are you... Well, you don't have movement left?
No.
Okay. Then you stay there.
That's a dead token.
No. You can just...
I got potions of keep token alive, don't worry.
I mean, you could, if all goes sour, you can just push him into the water.
Not to mention, I'm about to force feed him potions, so...
Interesting. That... Is that the thing we have? Let me just quickly check something. Oh, yeah. Okay, there we go. You hear some rushing of water, and then you notice that the tide is rising, and the dead bodies start floating down there. It's not as dramatically as you made it out to maybe be, but the water has risen.
Someone might have flushed the toilet.
Someone just opened a floodgate.
Somebody flushed the toilet, that's right. Cultists. Yeah, they did their thing. So, now let's see if he can see you. Of course he's got no sight.
Oh, I see him.
Yeah, okay, if you see him, he sees you.
Yep.
And he's like, So he casts that in front of you.
What?
You should, like, as the sword appears out of thin air, you're like, oh, wait, where's Eno? Eno, is that your sword? And then the sword goes to attack you.
Hang on, Doc.
Yeah?
I use my reaction.
Okay, react.
What level is his spell?
That's a level 2 spell.
I cast Counterspell.
Okay, you see that he's muttering something, okay?
Yep.
Oh, gosh.
Why is it so fucking... That's a really weird
Yeah,
spell.
That's really bad. So,
really
10 plus a spell level? Right? Is that?
Yeah, but if it's a second level spell, it just fails automatically.
Automatically fails casting it.
Okay, so while the sword is materializing in front of you, you quickly react and... Yeah. Poof! Poof goes the sword.
Thank God I got Counterspell.
Okay.
You're the close one, Token.
And
the bad news is that it was just his bonus action, though, so he still has an action.
Yeah, but... I'd rather not get basically.
That's fine. Let me see. That was his action. Would he still have... Is that... That's a... No, that's a...
Oh, wow.
I'm checking if he has any... Like, no, he doesn't. He's got nothing to... Unless that is one. I haven't checked that. It's all actions. No, he's all... He's like all actions.
Something is a bonus action, but casting it itself is an action. Also.
Yeah, but he doesn't have cantrips that he can use on that. Actually, wait, he
Funnily
does.
Enough, Doc, you encountered one of these, didn't you?
Wait. That is a cantrip. But yeah, doesn't work on you.
Yeah.
Yeah, it does. Roll me a dexterity save. Sorry.
But you can't see me now.
Yeah, he did it before he popped back into cover.
Oh, I see. Uh-huh.
He like shoop, quickly did something to you. Let's see if your dex save is high enough.
5.
No, you take 3 points of radiant damage, and then he just pops
radiant
back.
Damage.
Sacred flame.
That was sacred flame. Actually, we should call that Dark Flame or something. Sacred Flame sounds so good for a cultist.
Grimoire got taken out by a DMCA the other night.
Okay, that was his turn. Seldarin only gets your muttering, like, something like, what's going on? Like,
what's the... in that spell, the one, the ghostly sword?
The ghostly sword is spiritual weapon.
Thank you.
And he's like, ah, Tokan, you're blocking my way. can I step around you? Okay, so he wiggles.
Oh, no, one bonus action caster, right?
He wiggles his way around.
I keep an arm ready to catch Tokan in case the kitchen clanks into the water.
Yeah, it knocks me into the water.
And while he does come out, he gets shot by the arrow dude again.
I'll point to the corner, by the way, for Seldarin to let him know that.
I don't know what's wrong with my internet provider. Let me just stop the stream thingy. Sorry, no more points for you.
Dang it, I was so close.
It doesn't work if my internet drops constantly on that. There's no point in streaming it, so just a recording now. Well, anyhow. Where's my longbow? There we go. Boom! Arrow sticking right into the shield. Like, oh, yeah, he's still there. Archer, somewhere out there in the darkness. Milo.
Yeah.
Where is Milo? Milo, you didn't see anything happening with Tokan, right? You're just way too far behind.
Well,
I can bark and
see.
I can see that there's a guy around the corner.
Yeah, you hear him barking about Milo some dude around the corner.
Get over there, so instead, seeing as he's sneaking anyways, Milo's gonna head off in this direction. And he's gonna kind of, as he's going by, try to whisper and say, we can flank him.
Mm-hmm.
And then, that's pretty much it. Oh no, wait, I've got five more. Right there.
I'm just checking something for them, but they are awful. That's just so awful. Okay, Oct. I tried to hide the cultists, but they all rolled an 8.
Did you nice. Actually... I'm gonna say the Oct saw the cultist pop out, because I could see it at least. There's this... I can see this spot that he was there.
I'm sure you could. I'm just checking... Yeah, you can. What was that?
What the fuck was that?
He's just running up, checking out. No arrow coming. Okay. Yeah, Oct, you see this one cultist here who's trying to hide behind the pillar, but he's doing an awful bad job with that. It's really awful. Yeah.
Is he holding like a neon sign saying, I'm here?
No, not that, but he's like... He's hugging the pillar almost from the wrong side in order to hide himself.
So yeah, he has half cover or something.
He certainly has at least half cover.
Because gonna just head axe him.
Should be three quarter or something, but he's got half cover for you. Because he's kind of like, yeah, halfish. That one, surprisingly enough, hits him.
That is actually a surprise.
Yeah, so chip, X goes, flies, vroom, right into his side. He's like, ah! That's the first that everyone else hears somebody scream.
And then Oct is gonna like hide behind his shield. In case there's more sacred flames or something.
Mm-hmm.
And that's his turn. It's just, I assume that everyone saw where that bloody axe went, so they can figure where the guy is.
So, Ymir?
I'm gonna move past Tokan in there.
Okay, you're gonna move there. You remember that there's this one thing, the shadowy thing?
Yeah.
Even so, you have a hard time making it out.
Can I use my bonus action to swap to a different weapon, or...?
Yeah? What do you want to swap to?
My longbow.
Don't you have your longbow?
I have one.
What were you shooting with right now?
Shortbow.
Oh! yeah, sure. You just step one back, take one out.
Yeah, so I take aim and fire just once, because I swap my weapon.
A great help that was. Into the darkness it goes.
Sadly, my wolf doesn't have any light, so I can see him. So
and actually, I shouldn't have you all roll on disadvantage against him because he is standing in the shadows. But he has not a disadvantage because you're standing all around a big bright light source.
He's not obscured to people who don't have to dark vision, though.
He's got dark vision.
Yeah, no, but so do we.
But you don't really see him, do you? That's what I meant. You don't really see him, but he sees you perfectly because you're all around Seldarin with his light.
I still have movement, so I move forward a bit. And try to hide behind it a little bit, but yeah.
But, I mean, the good thing is that the dice so far knew something I totally forgot because that they are automatically rolled the lowest number they could for you guys. Sorry. But yeah, I mean, if you don't see him really, just it's disadvantage for you if you shoot up there. If we stay with the rules. Good! Now this poor Noel, he's like, ooh, so many to choose from. He's gonna shoot Ymir because Ymir is closest to the light source. And he's kind of like smart enough not to shoot the light source now that there's other people to shoot at. Plus, he already's seen the light source deflecting his shield. Anyways, 9 points of damage to you, Ymir.
Aww.
Yeah, you just get one arrow right into you. However, at seeing you guys coming closer, he does step back into the way there. Right, Tokan.
Oh, actually, that's got 25. Oh, hey!
Yeah, you can, like, walk around everyone. You can, like, hey, let me by. Is that counterspell the same level as the Tidal Wave? I don't know. I mean,
right. Because I only had one marked as used level 2, and I recovered it to 0 used. He's right. Last week I forgot to update it to the second.
Okay.
Tidal Wave.
Well then, just roll with it from now, so you don't have that spell stuff.
Oh yeah, I don't have any third level spells either. But yeah, that's my bad. Sorry.
Yeah, that's okay. I thought you when you recovered that you recovered something in that effect that you could use.
I recovered one, so I took it down to 0 used spell slots.
Okay.
But yeah, that was me being stupid.
Nothing really bad happened besides you just dispelled the sword. Right.
That was me last week being an idiot. I can still see the Noel Archer, but no. Shall I just burn this cultist? Question, Doc.
Yes.
Does this cultist have any frost fragments on his robes?
It has been a long time, and this one was not the one that was hit by the frost.
That's what I'm asking. Okay, cool. I'll hit him with a fireball. I hope I hit him.
It hits?
Fireball.
Yeah.
Nice.
Oh, wow. How do you want to do this?
Oh, Toka just kind of flicks his hand out, and the fireball, like, it just incinerates the guy. The guy is just blown away, basically.
Yeah, so, fire, boom! Human torch, then he just falls into the water, gets extinguished, but he's dead. Like, the damage, the shock, everything killed him.
And then I still have 10-foot movement left.
Okay. So you move higher up there.
Yeah, just so I have better vision.
So you see him, and he doesn't like that.
Fanatic. Yeah, I'll shout out and say he's just around the corner.
Yeah, that's fine. Oh, he's gonna do this. He's gonna do this now. You hear? It's his turn, right? No, it's the cultist's turn. They were hearing the screaming. They're like. So okay, they did their job.
God damn it!
Actually,
I don't know what these fuckers are doing.
Actually, let's see if they
making tea.
Yeah.
If they are better this time around.
Bacon.
No, they're still bad. Okay. Yeah. So everyone, now you see that there is out of thin air appearing, unless you have counterspell again, a sword that reminds you all of Eno's. Great
yep.
great spiritual weapon that she liked to use. But this one is gonna attack Tokan. Does an 18 hit you?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
If so, you take a whooping 2 points of damage.
Ow!
What?
Did that sting?
He's got a paper cut.
Yeah. and the cult is like, argh. And yeah, he's gonna.
Point, that's when you use cutting words and say, "I've taken more damage from a paper cut."
So he. Wait, let me just see.
I can still see him.
In theory, he has still 5 feet left. Can you see him?
Yeah, I can still see his the back of his cloak. He's there.
Yeah, so he is stepping 5 feet further back.
Okay.
That was his 30 right. feet
I'll
of sh- movement.
I'll say that he's passed down there.
Kind of like where you entered earlier.
Yeah.
Okay, Sildarin. He's like, what? Where? He's like, clank, 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 clank. He gets up there, clank, clank. I don't see anything. he stands here. He's ready. Like, if anything comes close to him, he's going to attack it with his sword. Milo.
Alright, so I'm first going to run up here. I don't see anyone.
Let me see. What you see? No, you don't see anyone.
And then I'm going to use my bonus action to dash, so I get to go to...
And you stop there.
Oh.
You stop Milo there. Not necessarily, Milo. As you are running, dashing forward, a scimitar comes down. You take 4 points of slashing damage.
He sees me?
Oh, yeah, he sees
like,
you.
Wall coming up? Okay. Crap.
That was definitely not hidden in that part. So you take 4 points of damage. Okay, oh, that was his reaction, though.
Well, Milo, stab. Just,
Milo stab. Nice to do.
Milo stab. Milo stab, one attack stab. Hits. You retaliate, with 7 points. Right, can you use the other one if you had your bonus action already for dashing?
No, I can't use the other one, that's why I didn't do it.
Okay, good. Perfect. You exchange stabbing and slashings with them. Mm-hmm.
This dick. And that's it.
Orked.
Wait, are we looping back again? I suppose I will check the water that the rose, like... can you see, like, marks in this wall or something that does the water come even higher?
No, it has risen to what it is now, but it's not rising higher.
Yeah, but are there like marks on the wall where you can see how high it can rise, you know?
No, you have the feeling it stays at that.
Yeah, okay, fine.
Or it should stay at that level.
He goes, excuse me?
Yeah.
And moves past the current master.
Let's you move past, yeah.
I suppose he'll just keep moving.
Mm-hmm.
So here first. Can you see anyone? Yeah, there's the...
Mm-hmm. But that was your action.
Yeah, he'll like take half cover or something, that pilar or something that stay here. Then he'll shot one more here.
Okay.
Which is of course very scary to the cultist being a gun. Yo, call it just one more.
Just one more. Yamir.
I'm gonna move close to Tokan. Swap out for a short sword. And just attack his flying knife.
I don't think you can attack a flying knife.
He can try.
You can try, yeah, help, but... Sorry?
Only got one health. I thought you could destroy them.
I'm not sure if it has any AC or anything like that.
Oh.
As far as I don't
it's
think it has.
It doesn't. You can't destroy it.
All right. Okay.
So I mean, you swing your short sword, and while you pass through the other blade, it just goes into thin air and then reforms as you cut through.
Interesting.
But it can only attack me. It can't. attack of opportunity me. It's not a separate person, is it?
No, it's not. No.
He has to take an action, yeah. Or a bonus action to attack me with it. Okay, cool.
So I'm going to stand where I am.
Yeah, but you used your action now, so there's nothing. I mean, you can, you know.
I have a second attack, but.
No, it's still the same action, second attack, but yeah, it doesn't really help you.
Doesn't really work, so I just.
You could try to cut the wall behind you if you want to, or step the ground. That's more solid than the sword.
Yeah, just step Tokaran.
Step Tokaran, yeah, sure. He's out of reach.
Throw my sword at Seldoran.
That's it?
Yeah.
That's it.
I'm gonna hold my attack for in case anything comes up behind me.
Right, the gnoll, he's like. Right. Actually,
there.
Which one can he see?
Still Darren.
Yeah, he's posing the best option for him to shoot, honestly.
Light bulb.
And he's been trying for fucking ever to hit him.
Yeah, but he also learned that he's having a hard time shooting him. For some reason, that this clanky armor is like really hard. So he's gonna go for Ymir again. Ymir, while you were holding your sword trying to attack the other one, second arrow hits you for 9 points of damage again.
What's it with the nines?
9, 9, 9, 9.
Just be happy it's just a 9. It's almost max damage he can throw. He stays there, he's like, they're not coming closer. Tokan.
Cool. I will take a bonus action. Use Misty Step.
Oh, okay, sure.
Do here. I will then move.
Is that what is that level 1 or level 2 spell? Just
two.
For...
I'm out of level 2s now. I'm on
okay.
3.
I was just curious about that.
Oh, hello.
Oh, yeah, you stand right in front of him. He's like, the wizard!
Tokan's like, well, okay,
screw you!
Panic throws a fireball. Like, oh shit!
Okay, bonus action, throw your fireball.
No, not a bonus action, just a normal.
No, I mean, your Mr. Step was your bonus action.
Panic throws a fireball.
Yeah, panic throw! Shoot! It goes wild! I think you just shoot it down the other way.
Well, you can aim.
Okay, he.
Are you sure?
You shoot this way. You shoot this way. I mean, come on, panic stricken. Okay, you shoot this way.
I got 120 rages.
You aim into the correct corridor, but you miss him.
Yeah. Oh! And, I'm gonna dash back here and be like, oh, he's all yours.
He's like, argh! Kinda like that.
Myself. I didn't expect him to be right there, so I genuinely, when I've moved Tokan.
No, not Og. The cultist, he's like, shit. That should be interesting now. Okay. Oh, hi, Milo. Yeah, you're getting some friends, some visitors. So, two attacks against you from the two cultists. You're nimbly, like, evading their stabs and slashes, and yeah, you don't take any damage. They rolled way too low for your... Yeah, you're way too fast. The cult fanatic, however... The cult fanatic. He steps forward. Kinda like... Kinda like there. So that Ork is not being hidden by that pillar. And he stretches out his hand to touch Oct.
Uh-oh.
Ooh.
What's this gonna be?
Some necrotic.
Yeah.
Oct, you take 30 points of necrotic damage.
What? Yeah, oh, it's inflicts are nasty.
Oh, is that inflict wound?
Yeah, it was inflict wound.
Oh.
And then, and then after doing that to Oct, he steps back.
Oh, do you get an attack of opportunity?
Although...
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, wait. Yeah, you do. Actually, that's a good point. Yeah, attack him. And while he's here, his sword is also still moving, because that's a bonus action for him.
Yeah.
Let's see...
Dildara, you're getting shanked in the back.
This one is going for Ymir, being the closest.
Okay. Poor Grandmaster. What a shit way to go. The Grandmaster gets offed by a ghost weapon.
Hey, more XP, man.
So, Ymir, you're getting slashed for 3 points of damage. And I'm still waiting for... And then he steps back, so Octia, roll your attack of opportunity.
Can I see him? Is he wearing, like, metal, or does he have more weapon or something?
He's got a big fancy cloak around him. It's hard for you to see what he has. So,
yeah. Doc, how much damage did I take? Because I had trouble hearing it.
3.
Oh. Man, that cleric is disappointing.
A lot more potent.
Yeah, your hand axe finds purchase, sinks in. Right. You have the feeling that this.
I was supposed to roll the misclicked. Can I add one more damage to that?
One more damage? Why?
I was supposed to use the Slayer's axe, but.
Oh, well. I guess if you do, you still have it. Didn't you throw it off somewhere?
No, I don't. No, I've been throwing normal hand axes.
Well, anyways, I think that 1 point doesn't matter. You hit him, you cut through leather, and he takes 8 points of damage. And when you take the axe back, it is bloodied.
Yeah, but now he has to do the concentration check to keep the sword up. So that's why I wanted to do the extra damage, because that's one more extra DC.
Concentration check.
Doesn't it would not have mattered. 8 or 9 damage gives him still the same DC 10.
All right, true. It gets half. I have to keep rolling that.
Yeah, for that you should have rolled over 10. Yeah. No, he rolls a 16. He holds on to the thing.
What a dick!
What a dick indeed! And he did step back successfully.
Yeah. Well, not successfully.
Well. So, clank, armor goes...
I should have been a necromancer. Look at that damage. That's insane.
He goes forward, like... He steps around the corner, and they stay eye-to-eye, toe-to-toe, and he swings his dragon sword. And misses.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he's like, blink! Totally misses that. He rolled
now we see where the guards are.
Oh, he rolled a 13 and a 5.
We see where the guards learned it.
Milo, it's your turn.
Alright.
He's still alive!
I'm attacking the one that hit me whenever I first approached.
Oh, almost got him. Yeah, okay, that one up here. Uh-huh.
Almost got
him. first one deals 5 points of damage, and the second attack goes for the same guy?
Yeah.
You stab him into the guts twice. He's bleeding heavily. He might be on his last breath.
One health.
Fucking hell.
So
mad. Oh shit. Okay. Yeah. Okay. That's it.
And that's your extra sharp daggers, right? That is already
yes.
Both of them dealing extra damage. That's pretty
good.
Yeah,
that's them.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Oct.
I rolled such shit on that hit.
Did I do the gnoll? Oh yeah, the gnoll was shooting Ymir, I remember.
Oh yeah. Probably take care of the gnoll.
But now the light source has walked towards where Oct and Oct is. Well, where Oct is.
Yeah, Oct's just gonna shout duck again and he's gonna try... actually, never.
You didn't take the gnoll.
Yeah, he's just gonna throw the hand axe that he clipped the guy after him when he drowns. So.
Okay, yeah, so you're shooting at him.
Nice.
Yeah,
you definitely hit him.
Probably killed him.
But no, he's still standing.
God damn.
He is still standing. He's tough.
By the way, in case you guys are wondering, he did actually take an ice knife to the face as well earlier on.
Yeah. And he holds on to the concentration.
Oh my god.
He rolled a 13.
A dickhead, this guy is.
I know, right? He's pretty good.
This is what happens when we come against enemy spellcasters.
That's cultist. I thought you liked this encounter. No, like spell versus spell. Just.
Hell.
I mean, he only has like level 1 or 2 spells, so that should be fine. anything else, Oct?
Give us a lich.
That one, but then he's done.
Okay, you're healing yourself for 6 points of damage.
Yeah.
Okay, you're not. I mean, you're still feeling drained and really down, but yeah, you regain a bit of health. Ymir?
I'm gonna run for my team.
Right, you run after them. Remember, you still have the short sword in your hand.
Yeah.
Okay, you don't see anything from there.
And from here, I swap to my short bow. Because I think I still have range. No, I don't have range.
And you really don't have sight on him. I mean, you... Disadvantage shot into the dark, you know where he should be. What's the range on that?
Oh my...
The short bow. Yeah, it has enough range, but
yeah,
that...
Put it in range.
That would be disadvantage.
I'm gonna soften my longbow again, and sharpshoot on disadvantage.
Sharpshoot on disadvantage. Alright. Yeah. Hit me.
Hello.
Yeah, hit me.
Come on, two natural 20s.
So
close. You pull back the string like almost until it springs, and then you let loose, and that arrow embeds itself almost halfway into the wall.
Wow, fucking hell, there's a lot of strength behind that.
Yeah, 17 points of damage to the wall, but
yeah.
It's a miss.
Guys, I damaged the structure.
Great.
I hope it's not a construct elemental.
Yes, we get annihilated.
Okay, then Noel. He's like... Shitty people. But
a dick.
But sadly, it still has the best line of sight, I believe, towards Oct, who's standing with his back to the knoll. And why am I always trying to move it? Stay there. God damn it, longbow. Longbow against Oct. No, Oct, while you're hiding behind the pillar, choo! Arrow sticks right over your head into the pillar. Like, if you would be a normal human, it would have hit you right in the back, but no, you're smaller than a normal human, so you're fine. Dokkan.
Finish this.
Sure.
Step up. Yeah, maybe, if I can fucking hit.
You could. Everything is possible tonight.
Hey!
That one hits, yeah. How do you want to do this?
Yes! So Tokan steps out, flicks his hand forwards, and just looks the cultist in the eye, who he's already, like, beat the shit out of quite a lot, and just goes, be gone.
Yeah, and he's like, yeah, he sees that fireball coming, like, yeah, I dodged one of those earlier, and then he just jumps into the wrong direction.
Like, unrecognizable face after... Tokan clicks his finger.
Yeah, definitely, and he does drop into the water too.
Oh,
we need to keep... Oh, now I cut myself on my knife.
Another 10 movement. There we go. That's it. Okay, I can see Milo now. Oh my god.
He's like, yeah, you're waving to Milo. Hey, Milo!
2 minutes, Milo.
Hey, I'm doing fine.
The cultists, they hear that their leader has fallen, more or less, I guess, in his... And they're giving their best to cut down Milo before they too will join, and no, they fail. Both of them are running for, let's see, where are they running? I mean, they came from downstairs, they should be running down. Yeah, they should be running. So Milo, you have the opportunity. Which one of those are you gonna react to?
The one that's nearly dead, and if I do hit, I'm actually going to try and get his Achilles heel instead so he can't run away, but he's not dead.
Okay, good. Try. Yeah, he drops to the ground, unable to run off.
Oh, it's spraying from his ankle.
I'm guessing he would be paralyzed.
I mean, he'd be prone. He wouldn't technically be paralyzed.
But he cannot get up, really, either.
Yeah. True.
Let's just have him paralyzed so that he's not running away or doing anything. Okay, and the other one is... There. Okay. Cult Fanatic is dead. Mr. Clanky Clank is like... Clank, 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 clank. Mr. Hillshire, are you alright? No, actually, maybe Milo. So he comes around the corner, gets his weapons ready in case anything happens.
I've incapacitated this cultist so that we can question him properly. And with that, Milo kind of brandishes his dagger and kind of points it threateningly at the cultist.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Oct.
Oct turns around with his shield out, so he's not going to be shot in the back, and he'll back off.
Okay. Ymir?
I'm going to follow the group.
All right.
And no then one... oh, before Oct's turn is over, he's going to...
Okay, you drink the... That's a regular healing potion, yeah?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That's fine. Ymir follows you. That gnoll is like, ah, where'd the light go? Actually, let's see. It's a tough luck there, I believe. Would he? I mean, he still sees the light. So, Ork, you're still being shown upon from behind. So there's gonna be one more attack against you before he's... before you hear some footsteps. Nope, misses, and... doop, 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 you hear some footsteps up north, running down a long corridor. And I believe with this... we end the combat.
Right.
One cultist escaped. You took one... one cultist escaped south, and Noel escaped north, and you took one cultist hostage.
Alright. Milo walks up to the cultist, puts his dagger to his throat, and says, you will answer our questions, or this dagger will find its way through your throat.
How close are you to him?
I'm standing right here next to him.
Okay. Give him intimidation. So he's like, he's begging you to come closer.
Milo.
He's like, he's trying to say something, but it's like it's very quiet, so you would need to lean forward.
Milo puts his hand up and says, "You try anything. I promise you I'm quicker," and then leans forward to listen.
And at that, Milo, give me a dex save.
Can I also be immediately trying to stab him in the throat?
That would definitely hit regardless. You don't need to roll for that. You will hit him, but I need to see your dex saving throw. Yeah, while you're coming closer, he tried to dagger you. He had like this little tiny mini dagger hidden by the side, but he fails and you just stab him and he just bleeds out.
As the life drains from his eyes, I've just said, "I told you I was quicker."
The hand goes limp, the tiny dagger just clatters to the ground.
Milo takes the tiny dagger. Is it like a normal dagger, or is there anything?
It's just a normal dagger.
Noticeable.
Yeah, right.
I mean, in your hands, it looks like a regular dagger. In his hands, it would be a bit smaller.
I'm pulling this guy out of the water up on here.
Uh huh. Yeah, you.
I'm searching him for anything useful.
Okay. Yeah, that's a thing now. That's right. Yeah, you can search him for loot.
Well, not just loot. Specifically, I'm actually looking for a nice one, Milo. Smooth.
Hold on, halfling luck.
Oh, yeah.
What?
Yay,
yes.
There you go.
He tried to jump down.
Yeah, and investigation, right, Doc?
Yeah, it's investigation.
Milo's actually going to be walking on the ceiling right now. Is that possible? Can I, like, walk around on the ceiling right
well,
now?
Well, you could be jumping onto the next wall and then run up to the ceiling. Yeah, it would be possible. It begs the question why you haven't done that earlier.
To see if I find anything related.
I honestly kind of forgot.
Value in terms of information or...
Yeah, let's handle Tokan's dead prisoner first. Tokan, while you ruffle through his belongings, you first of all find 12 pieces of gold. Milo, don't run away too far, or I'll just have you being killed by something, like the ceiling collapsing. Just saying that. If everyone runs off everywhere, that's going to be hard to keep track of. Other than that, since you did Singe kill burn off his face, his cloak is fairly intact. You notice that there is, on the inside, on the back side of the cloak, and the inside, there's a huge black circle with a purple rim. Purple circular, rim around it.
A religion check? I believe this.
I
can't use my. See. Or would it be Arcana?
Religion. No, that would be more religion for that.
What was the thing, sorry?
It's a black circle with a purple circlet around it with a purple border, basically.
And fucking roll, honestly. Try that again. There we go. 15, there you go.
You are sure that this is a cultist belonging to the cult, you would call it cult, they call it church, but to the cult of Shah. S-H-R-A-R. Wait, I'm just there. Shah. It's basically a cult that likes to make other people's lives miserable.
Darkness and loss.
Yeah, they like to make people miserable.
The symbol was a pair of eyes by seven stars, according to your thing.
Sorry?
Never mind. I thought their symbol was something else, according to your gods of the world.
Did I just miss that up? Let me just check.
Surrounded by seven stars.
Sure. Give me a moment, because I used Shah earlier. I might have just done something wrong there then. Shah. Goddess of Darkness Lost, pair of eyes around. Is there no black with. Oh, I thought there was something. Black, and none of this wrongly depicted for you. It should be black with a purple.
That's alright.
Let me just double check that. D&D, sure. Yeah, it's black with a, then I'm sorry, then the symbol in the thing is wrong.
Okay, that's fine. I just want to keep a note of it, so I want to make sure I have it right.
Yep.
But Zorkan shakes his head. Cultist of Shar.
You also find that he's got a tinderbox to light fire.
Yeah.
And he's got besides that, he's got this dagger that he never used on you.
I'll take the dagger and I'll use it to cut the symbol out of
Brock, you're always quiet.
Okay, so you cut the symbol out.
I take a piece of cloth with the symbol, and I'll fold it up and put it inside my pouch. Mm-hmm. Or inside my pack.
Yeah, besides that, you don't really find much on him. I mean, he's got a spell pouch component thingy, but you don't need that really.
I will stock up anything I'm missing from my component pouch.
You can do that. Other than that, the rest of his stuff is pretty much ruined.
No paperwork or parchment specifically?
Nothing on him. He must have been smart enough to keep his mission objectives in his head.
Fair enough. So yeah, after that I'll step over him.
Okay, then I guess we have Ymir looking
looking
for the other one, right?
I'll just check this cultist for anything that's useful.
Yeah, not much. You find 8 silver, a bloodied clothing that he has now, and he does have this scimitar, this curved swords.
I like curved swords. I'm picking that up.
It's not the best quality. It's good enough, but yeah, you have seen better. What are you making there? Are you burning it?
I'm burning the bodies. Fuck cultists. They don't get to. Their bodies get burned.
Okay. Whatever.
Plus, I needed to amuse myself whilst everyone else does stuff because I got.
And Doug, how much does the scimitar weigh?
Don't you have a player's handbook?
I have a weapon details page, but it doesn't really say. Oh, that says. Yeah, 3.
Because otherwise I wouldn't have to whip out mine.
Yeah, that says spatula for a second.
That's a very nice fire.
Yeah.
Very good looking. I'm impressed.
Anything else on this guy? Like a hood or something?
Nope. Jewelry. Not much. Not much other than that.
And they even take his cultist hood.
Do you want to take his cloak that has been cut and ripped in pieces?
Well, only the headpiece.
You... make an investigation check. Okay, yeah, you could take his hood.
God.
Do you want to use it now or later?
I'm just taking it off to look at a guy's face.
Huh?
What a shit thing, crit fail, huh?
Wait, you take off the hood from his cloak, and then?
Then I'll just put it in my pocket.
You put it in your pocket, okay.
Yeah, a pocket with no other stuff in it.
So anything else you guys want to do? You know that there one guy ran south, Noel ran north.
I kind of want to go try and investigate the direction that the cultists ran.
I'll go with Milo.
Okay, you both can roam investigations. Right, this is leaving the map, basically.
I'm still in on the ceiling.
That's great for looking for footprints or anything else.
Of course.
Even that, you user joined your channel. Rolled quite high.
User left your channel.
Hi, user. Bye, user.
Someone misclicked.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Yeah, Italian DM.
Tokan, any investigations?
I did.
He rolled.
Oh, he rolled a 13, sorry. Yeah, his the magnificent Milo Hillshire's intelligence check there just took the spot. Tokan, you don't see anything, but Milo, you notice that the cultists took this tunnel down south.
So, which of the two targets shall we row up and kill? The dog person, or...
We should go after the gnolls after they killed all the civilians. And we need to stop them before they are getting more.
Well, obviously, the cultists are to blame for it, though. Gnolls aren't smart enough to do this. And
Milo, how about you go fetch this cultist for us?
At this, Milo's just kind of going further in. Because he is also looking for those bodies, the rat guy had mentioned, but it comes to a dead end, so...
The what thing you mentioned?
The swift rat rogue had mentioned something about bodies, or missing people.
Yeah.
So he's looking for either people or bodies.
You could all roll me intelligence, or see if you can remember anything about the gnolls.
Down here.
Milo will be going back as soon as I roll that.
Oh.
Roll shit, so it doesn't matter.
I think
Amir is the smartest thing in the group right now. So, Yamir, you're looking for Tokan, and you walk up to him and like, hey, Tokan, don't you have that book of yours? Ask it about gnolls.
Huh? Sure. Tokan removes the book and checks it for gnolls. I presume gnolls is going to be a pretty easy arcana check. Everyone knows about them. Just in case. 23.
Yeah, that's good enough. So you concentrate on gnolls, and the page pops up. Ugly thing, just as you have seen it out there. And you skip through, you know, like browse through that, blah, 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 see how they're being created. Blah, blah. And then you come past this one little line that cautions, like, if there is a gnoll that has been touched by the demonic powers, it will be able to swiftly create more gnolls. It carries on to read, this one must be sought out and killed if gnoll infestations are, you know, to be stopped.
Looks like we're hunting gnolls.
Read that to Ymir and shrug. I guess.
What does the book say?
The book says that if any of the gnolls have been touched by demonic powers, and I presume the... Although Shar is a god, it's not a demon, is it?
Let's see. Shar is a dark god, possibly god. Has access to demons.
Possibly.
So, it would be better if we hunt down this dog person and kick his ass.
Sure. Let's go hunt down another one.
There was no mention of Shah, by the way, in that description when you were reading. That was actually a different
goddess of Shah.
Yeah, a different god there. They had like their own. I mean, Toka knows that they had like their own little Yensha or something. Yenshu. Something. They have like an old god, some demon.
Clifford the Red Dog.
You don't want to encounter this thing.
I've encountered it plenty of times in third edition.
Are we calling it soon?
No, we still have an hour.
Do we?
Yeah, we still have an hour. It's just six. We go till seven, right?
Sorry, I'm so used to Canadian. I'm really fucked up at the moment.
I'll just put you back to this one because you're still in the sewer system and we don't have everything marked out. So just enjoy enjoy the show of that and have your memory and your mind play the story. So you follow the gnolls and so Darren, he is really happy about that. You follow him deeper into the sewer system. You keep on walking for quite some time.
That's a little bit creepy, isn't
it? Yeah, you could have a short rest if you want to, if you still have hit dice left to recover. You don't want to take a short rest?
I still have one hit dice to my use.
I do, but I'm not going to bother using it.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not going to bother either.
So, you, nature dude, ranger, no, he doesn't say that. Ymir, can you see if you find the tracks? And Ymir, you may roll with advantage on your survival check to see if you find the gnoll. Because it's a favorite enemy of yours, isn't it?
Grace spotted, sir.
Oh gosh, there we go. You find the tracks easily. And it takes another half an hour, 45 minutes. When you arrive at another junction and you all hear a lot of noises. This is not, they're not that loud, but there's a lot of noises. It sounds like hyenas. Loads of hyenas. I don't know how they sound like, Jesus. So I'm not gonna make the sound for you.
Okay, you hear that?
Yeah.
Yep, you all hear
them out, shall we?
So let's see.
Yeah, we can see the whole map, Doc.
Oh, you can. That's bad. Just forget that you saw that.
Yeah.
There we go. Better.
Yep.
I need Ymir. Roll me a. Wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Roll me a 1d6. So we know which way you're coming into this craziness.
Please don't roll a 3.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's decent. You're coming down from the north.
Okay, cool.
Which is, yeah, I mean, you walked around, you thought north, west, and then now you're coming down that way. So I'll be popping your tokens in there in a minute. There's no Feldrill tonight. There's a Milo. I know Milo you cannot see. I'll rectify that in a moment. I changed that. There's a Ymir. And there's the Sildaren. Of course, you're not that far down. You're all just really kind of like up there at the very beginning of the map.
Yeah.
With Ymir first. Hold still there, Milo. I need to give you some light. 360 has sight. Is that better, Milo?
Yes.
Okay. Is that your desired order of walking?
Also, where's my doge?
It died on the way here. It drank from the water.
Would I need to re-roll stealth if I wanted to be stealth?
Yes, please, here you need to roll stealth newly, freshly. It's a new map.
Sure, let's all do it.
Yeah, let's roll stealth for Sildaren.
Good success.
Nice.
Well, he rolled a 12.
Why are you rolling on disadvantage, Og?
Because he's got heavy armor, he has to roll on disadvantage.
Oh, okay. Wow.
Well,
that's so not worth it.
How How high is the ceiling?
The ceiling here, since this is a major corridor, I'd say that be like 15 feet at least.
Milo's gonna climb up to the ceiling.
Let's see. So this is like 15 wide, 15 high. It's not a square though. It's more like you know, like how those corridors are shaped in a half circle. Yeah, you know what I mean.
Milo's gonna climb up to the top to kind of be able to peer out and maybe not be noticed as easily.
Since we don't have fly, I give you wings. You're up on the ceiling. Okay. So, as for the hearing, you hear a lot of hyenas from that direction. And you can make out that from here there's more sounds, but they sound a lot fainter.
Okay, go. So are we going to push forward or go for support? I have almost no spells left.
Yeah, you and me both.
I still have all but one spell slot because he slumbers more. Mm. Next session. Still got my heal of tons.
By the way, did Dog manage to like recover any of his hand axes from last time?
Oh yeah, you got all your hand axes back. I don't think anybody escaped alive.
I'm going to say that I lost at least one because I'm not going to go and get it from the sewage, so... Yeah.
Okay, you could just lose one of your hand axes that just bloop, water, and gone.
Yeah, I only have 13 arrows at the moment because some of them shattered. Well, both of them.
We should press on.
So there are nods of that. Yeah, if we don't stop this thing, we could have more
I'm
of
more
those
worried about the cultists of Charm, what they want to do with the
hands.
Nose.
Right then, Yemi, what was your stealth?
Eight.
I'm just gonna put this in there so I remember.
Oh yeah, I need to rock on my wolf.
Mm-hmm. Milo, you had a 12.
Yeah.
So let's check out with them. Dum, dum, dum. So the party goes up. You could just say what you're doing when you're sneaking up so that I know if I need to tell anything.
I mean, Milo's just kind of keeping an eye out.
Okay, well, Milo, you look down this corridor. It looks empty to you.
Cannot see anything there.
Now, am I going to kind of... Oh, sorry. Whoever.
Let's see. You see that there's two openings. And from you listening, you can... ascertain that there is the sound of the hyenas coming from there, but you don't know what's in that opening.
So yeah, let's a bit closer to the rest of them and go says like semi quietly. We can't leave them at our backs, people.
Let's just take care of the major problem, then we can deal with those.
And yeah, we were supposed to eradicate the nose. There's some there.
Does Milo see what he sees?
What do you mean? Like that? Yeah, you see that there is you see one of them? No, you see that there's at least one you see, and then there's another foot standing there in this little alcove.
Yeah.
Your friends don't see that yet, I believe.
Yeah. Milo's walking back over here and as quietly as possible without coming down, just goes
15 feet up in the air, up there on the ceiling.
Yeah. He's just trying to whisper down. There are two ahead of us. They're in an alcove to the right.
Notice.
Clank, clank, clank. What did you say?
Milo turns to the walk-in noisemaker and says, "Shh. There's two of them ahead." And at that, Milo's gonna kind of keep pressed against the wall while walking this way.
Just need to light up the flame.
Milo stops.
Okay. Dips the hand into his component pouch. And flicks his wrist. Throws sand out here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not starting a fight, I'm just...
No, just do that. Just preparing the turn order.
And he casts sleep.
Yeah, okay.
Please roll really high.
22. Wait, what?
What?
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
It's lower.
Do you cast sleep?
Neither.
You don't hear any changes of noises there. But, yeah, let's see. Let's see what Ork is doing.
We'll do it another two times if we want. If we want to keep
trying. I think the others are kind of sneaky right now. I'm just waiting for the rest to do something so we can have them.
I'm holding the attack ready in case something comes up.
Okay, so you're ready your attack.
Milo's still pressed against the wall while cautiously approaching.
If you approach, I can't do sleep again.
You're up there and you see that they're kind of like. You see them watching out this way. They haven't seen you because they're not looking up. They're not looking up. They're just looking.
They're not looking up.
No, they're looking straight ahead. They're kind of like looking this way and that way and that.
I have an idea. Why don't we ambush them if I use thaumaturgy to cause a sound on the opposite side?
But if you start discussing things, they will hear you.
Milo is still walking forward. You said they're not looking up currently.
They're not looking up currently.
Milo, as quietly as possible. Sneaks up right above this one.
Yeah.
And Milo is going to yell now while plunging down with both daggers on top of this one.
Right, Milo, you give me a surprise attack and then we're going to see what happens.
Do I also get advantage on
this? Yeah, you have advantage and you have sneak attack because they didn't know that you were there. Now, if I... would you please step to the side so I can click on the token?
Maybe.
Well, I can apply the damage to you if you want to.
Nah.
So, that's 6. That's... Oh, that second one is a miss.
A 25 is a miss?
No, the 15 is a miss. Oh, advantage, sorry. Yeah, okay. Minus 4.
I was like, oh god, I made a mistake.
And 11. So... Right then, let's put yourselves to the turn order, please. Oh gosh. Yeah, that fits them well, landing at the bottom of that thing.
Oh, I just remembered the dog has advantage on initiative, so...
True, you may roll again. That much better.
Is he not at disadvantage because of the heavy armor, though?
No, that's because of his shield gives him...
Oh, okay.
Higher stats on that. 1, 2, 3, 4... Oh, yeah. I know who's missing.
The heavy armor only affects stealth checks.
Captain Kitchen
gets the first roll, though.
So, Milo, you're currently sitting on top of the knoll. And all the noises bring Seldarin up. So he's kind of like trying he's running forward, trying to keep them in the alcove. Actually, yeah, he's kind of like positioning himself like right there in the middle. So they cannot get out of there. Locked.
Well, if he stands there, they can't get out. They get an attack of opportunity anyway. If he takes up the full spot space.
Well, he would. They wouldn't. If they go by him, he's gonna attack them. But he's kind of like trying to keep them in there, boxed in as best as he can.
Okay.
So how much noise are we making right now?
That running heavy armor is a lot of noise.
True. Yeah.
Eldarin just sprinted up. So.
Clanking through the hallway, echoing deeply into the
path. Definitely, you're making noises.
Yeah, that thing might have like partial cover from Oak, but he's gonna hit throw the hand axe there.
Would it have partial cover? No, it's not partial coverage. It's not. I don't think so. Nope, that's fine. Yeah, you hit. Bam. Into his shoulder plates. 6 points of damage. I hope I applied it to the correct one.
And Oak will not shout, but he'll state confidently and relatively loudly that keep an eye on our backs, they will come swarming.
Very intriguing, very good. Okay, Tokan.
Tokan steps up, looks at the one Milo's. So wait, you hit this one, right?
The one on the right.
Milo is riding on the one that he almost killed.
So that one's looking pretty bad.
It's looking pretty bad, with Milo on his back stabbing at him.
The other one then, if I kill that. So let's firebolt the one that Milo's hurt badly.
Please not a crit fail, please not a crit fail.
Please a crit fail, please a crit fail.
I would cry.
That misses. Yeah, even so, that is a very confined space. You try not to hit Milo, and it goes against the wall. At least it was not a crit fail. Milo,
shank him.
Milo kind of jumps down behind him and uses his offhand to attack the one that he nearly killed.
Uh-huh. You want to use your sneak attack? No, wait. There is somebody in front of him. Doesn't that works when...
Does that kill him or no?
It kills him not. The 5 does not kill him.
Alright. Then Milo's going to go ahead and do sneak attack on that one.
What's your rogue class again? Are you a thief?
Thief.
Alright, okay.
Yeah, so how?
Oh, I just... it goes right into his spine and just snaps it right then.
Perfect.
And then with my main hand, I'm going to attack the other one now.
Ooh! Yeah, take 7 points of damage, you just stab it in the kidneys, it is still alive.
I know, that was such a terrible roll.
Should it survive, you have the feeling that it will turn around and try to gut you.
That's perfectly fine.
Oh my god, that is the worst crit. Fucking hell.
I know.
Sorry, I was tapped out for a second. I tapped back in, looked at your roll, and went, oh my god.
Good luck, Ymir.
I wish I'd used sneak attack on it.
Yeah.
I'm gonna stay where I am, but Playlon is gonna move forward.
You could move him right on there.
They don't have enough movement.
They have 40 feet.
Ah.
There.
Yeah. So, rotating correctly. Moving myself a bit closer to have the vision so that I can see everything better.
Okay, if it attacks, it has advantage because Milo is considered his ally.
Captain Kitchen, is it?
Captain Kitchen is as well. Yeah, 7 points of piercing damage. That's decent. Whatever your name.
Can I make him have my second attack as well?
No, that comes later.
Okay, just wanting to know because I have a second attack, so I can.
Nope.
I'm not going to shoot because.
Nope.
Too many
nope. You have one action. The action is you attack twice or your wolf attacks once.
Okay, so Thaemon has bitten. I'm going to ready my arrow in case.
It makes
attacks.
A strength save. Let's see if your wolf brings him to its knees. Oh, wow! Yeah! The wolf runs up, bites him into the leg, and the gnoll goes prone.
Good job, boy. Keep the bastard down.
Okay. it's a prone one.
So yeah, another speed makes me skip his turn.
So, being prone, it gets up again and it takes out its two-handed battle axe and it's... Does it one have... No, it doesn't. It has the sword. Sorry. The long sword, two-handed. Turns towards Milo and tries to gut you with that. No, Milo, you evade. You just step back and the long sword just... But that wasn't it.
What kind of rogue would I be otherwise?
Yeah, that wasn't it. So, dum 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 dum. Of course, all that clanky armor was not that unnoticed.
Unfortunately. No pack lord, great.
Yep, but he will move later. Let's see, is there anybody else left? Nope, that's it.
I'm back. What happened?
Nothing. Milo almost got killed, but didn't.
Good
end
job.
Up.
No.
Not, you know,
no,
he
Milo,
didn't.
Milo dodged it.
So while it is turned fully towards Milo, Seldarin crits hits it on the back, and it just... Milo, you see that a tiny piece of short sword sticks out in front of the gnoll, just as, you know, barely visible, but since it is flaming, you can make out, oh, it has been stabbed from behind, and it dies.
Good.
To the back. To the back. And then Sardarin steps back, looks behind, and he's like, more coming from behind. Here we go, Oct.
We have a lot of behind here. And so he'll start back in there. And then he'll look into the area and he'll notice that it's a dead end and he'll curse because that seems like a good place to hole up in. And then he's gonna move a bit more and then he's done.
Okay.
Can we like hear anyone running towards us or something like that?
Somewhere. Nope.
That was the question, basically.
No, you don't hear anything. It's like stuff coming from that direction now.
In that direction, and he'll have one of the axes out. So, if something gets 20 feet, he'll draw it. But otherwise, nothing.
Tokan, before you start, do a perception check, please.
Yes, sir.
Since you are the one furthest down the line there.
There you go.
Pretty decent. You do see that there is a corner here, right? From that direction, somewhere, you hear a female scream. Human female scream that is then being silenced.
Oh,
somebody died.
Yep.
Not too far away.
That's fine.
Far enough, though, that you will not catch him.
If it's a scream, did we all hear it or just him?
It was just him because he was closest
Wait,
to
no,
there.
I only wanted to go 20 feet, sorry.
Okay.
How far am I to the Pack Lord?
You don't know, because you don't see him.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering. Well, I know where he was, though, Doc.
No, he has not appeared yet.
Oh, I thought that was the Pack Lord. Oh, well, whatever that
No, is. You'll see the one that is the Pack Lord.
Okay, we're gonna start there.
Actually,
there.
You don't see him, but yeah, he's gonna be... I'm going to point him out.
10. Okay, so I'll move another 10 foot and I'll fire a disadvantage shot.
Sure.
At where I know the gnoll was over there.
Oh, right, you can't see him, right? Yeah.
No,
that's...
he's out of my sight now. But yeah, I saw him before I left, so I know he's not moving.
Sure. Yep, disadvantage shot on him.
Yep. Through all your teammates.
No, that actually, it hits. So the fireball just zooms by the people, and it illuminates two gnolls that are rushing towards you, and one of them gets hit. And for a moment there, you can see him, and then the flames die down.
Yep.
Definite impact. Milo.
Alright, so Milo... runs back up onto the ceiling from here. Does that use my normal movement, or does that...
No, that's a regular movement. You just walk up the wall.
Alright, so that uses, like, what, 15 feet? So I've got another 10. So I just end up on the ceiling. I'm right here.
In the middle.
Just so I can see. Yeah.
Yeah, and since you're so tiny, and although... you're right over Sardarin, who's holding up the torch. So, being tiny on the ceiling normally would help you, but this time, right over the dude with the lamp, they
Freaking
see you.
Sardarin.
They see you. They point
Hi,
out.
Guys.
They point out while they're running to us, like.
Well, shit! I forgot about his stupid lamp.
You All can right. see it, can you not? There's a circle, right? Right.
Yeah,
right.
But it's... Damn it, I forgot about it.
That's fine. You end your turn there?
I'm not... Yeah.
Okay. For those with very good hearing, you can hear some roaring, something stamping down the corridors. Somewhere from that direction there. Sounds like a really angry one. With that, it's Ymir's turn.
Ranger Instinct, I'm gonna move way back.
That one should now give you disadvantage on him, but that's fine, isn't it?
Yeah, but I'm gonna move here behind, well, behind Orc.
Mm-hmm.
I'd still be a disadvantage shot, wouldn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're pretty down there in the darkness. It's just the limit of your 60 feet.
Until they get into this line.
Okay.
I'm gonna hold an arrow until they get here.
Sure, that's a regular shot then. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I was gonna wait for stuff to attack, be in this slot.
Ah, shoot, they cannot run that far.
So, yeah, that concludes my turn.
Okay, so the gnolls. Actually, who cares? They're just gonna charge up so you can shoot him.
Doc, because he crossed this line.
Yeah, I know, that's why I said you can shoot him.
Yeah, so that's a longbow, non sharpshooter.
I'm thinking, can you use sharpshooter as a sharpshooter on the reaction?
Yeah, it's just a choice of attack, Doc. It just literally changes his attack to a sharpshooter attack.
Okay, good, yeah. Then you hit him.
Just go rolling with a normal one.
Unless, is sharpshooter an action of itself, or is it literally just...
No, he just needs to declare it as a sharpshooter shot.
Can I use Hail of Thorns?
You have to say that that's the spell you've prepped. You have to prep a spell.
Nah, you only have one reaction. You shot, that's it.
Okay.
Done. Reaction. I mean, you were holding your action there. It's not... You know what I mean.
Yep.
Okay, well, they're out of movement. So Darren getting rushed, yeah?
Wasn't that... I thought... Did you say that was going to be sharpshooter or no?
If you hold your action, you can... I'm sure you can shoot once.
Well, I meant, like, wouldn't sharpshooter add 10 more to the damage?
It did.
What sharpshooter does?
That is 10 more to the damage.
No, it isn't.
Oh shoot! You know what? The guy that just rushes up to Seldarin, after reaching him, he realizes that his heart had stopped working, and he just bloop, falls down.
Yeah, that's
all right.
Insta kill.
Seldarin's like, huh? Which you don't need to lay down in front of me.
I'm not a god, come on.
So he goes there, because he's stupid enough to do that. He attacks, but there's nobody close enough for advantage, so... Ooh... 8... And another 8 points of damage. Yeah, you see him just stabbing him, slashing him, and the fire illuminates the area for a brief moment. Wow, he's doing pretty good.
Ordo Incompetentis.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he's part of the Ordo Competentis.
Yeah.
Come on, he's a Grandmaster. He's like a half a knight. Actually, he's a knight, but yeah. Psst. We don't tell you. Right, Oct.
No. Let's keep things simple, so...
No rushing towards you.
Well, we needed one of those decisions.
Yeah, let's see. What was you using? You were using your Slayer's Axe.
Yes,
you're charging forward, swing your axe, and it flies out there. Comes to a halt somewhere on the pavement.
Fine.
At least not... Something else happened. That's not the worst that could happen to your weapon.
Imagine the head falling off as you swing it and landing on Milo.
Milo's on the
That wouldn't have been too bad. Like, it would have been better than this.
Sorry? What was that?
Nothing important.
Okay. You could try as your second action to pummel him with your fist, or to just really, really quickly try to grab another hand axe.
Yeah, that's what he does. It's
okay.
Reaction
okay.
Anyway, so he'll have one more axe. Actually, he gets his warhammer. Not playing anymore with axes. But yeah, that was his turn. He can do moves in the next one.
Okay, Tokan, one more perception roll, please. I need to build up the tension here.
Yeah, well, I'm about to find out exactly what it is anyway, hopefully. Only 11.
It's not too bad. The noises come from here.
Yeah.
And what you're gathering is the hyenas, they're really happy that whatever died there, they're going to be really happy about that.
Great.
So, yeah. Okay, do your turn then.
It's nothing.
Of course not, because that thing has a bend.
And I will hold my actions, cast fireball.
Okay.
If anything shows up in my range.
Hmm? Milo?
I think we're just going to see an instant replay. Just plunge down on him.
Good luck.
Halfling luck on the second one.
Right, so he takes minus 5. I hope I grabbed the right
and
person.
And then I also get sneak attack because Og's within 5.
Literally.
13. Wow, I don't know how you do this all the time.
Oh, you got rid of my health.
Oh, was that you?
Yes, that was me.
Then, sorry. Milo that
drops down, he dies.
Plus, let me just put you plus 13. Do not move away. Did I apply the other damage to you too?
I should be way above that. I was at 23.
Yeah, I think I applied all the damage to you. See, that happens when you step on top of the thing. Minus 5.
I know, right?
Minus 4. Okay, you kill him.
Alright.
Try not to die next time. Yeah, you come falling down from the sky and it's dead.
Alright, then I use the rest of my movement to start heading back towards where Tokon had headed off. And I can get there. Alright, I'm good.
Mm-hmm. So what now comes around the corner, that is the Null Pegwort.
Looks the same.
It looks, yeah, the Fang of Yang Shu looks different. I'm sorry about that. But you know, like, when you look at him, he looks a bit bigger. Actually, you know what? I can make him bigger. There you go. Is that better? Does this represent his more HP and being beefier than the others?
Yep.
Okay. So he comes there, and when he spots all of you, he lets out a loud howl, like an You hear some hyenas answering in the back, and then he's rushing forward. It's not gonna help him much, but yeah. You know, he's a peglaw. What else is he supposed to do other than attack? Attack!
Let's see. Oh, it would be best if you duck. I'm gonna apply Hunter's Maul. I'm gonna prepare my Hail Thorns in case I hit.
Okay.
Then I'm gonna sharpshoot this guy. Twice. Shoop, shoop.
One goes wide. The other one actually hits. Did you Hunter's Mark him?
Nope. But I did prep Hail Thorns.
Just prep that so he takes minus that. Minus that. He takes minus 3. Does it do anything to him?
He has to make a deck save.
Well,
so does celery while kept in kitchen.
I know that he's going to do that right now. Now, I mean, is there a spell save card to that? Are they like being treated to be stopped there? Can they move?
Well, let's see. What does the spell say?
Yeah,
I think they just take the damage.
Or half.
Yeah, that's fine.
So either 3 or 1.
He took the damage.
Okay.
And Seldarin did take 1.
Okay, and the null?
Well, he took the damage.
Okay.
He still looks very beefy.
Even after 19 in the face?
It's a null pegwort. It's big.
I'm gonna move back a bit. Salem is gonna move there.
Right, since there's no currently no regular nodes around, Sildaren stands there. He's like, oh shoot. So he's gonna attack. Hopefully, hitting something. Miss, miss, miss. His attacks are missing.
Great, so Darren, you're doing awesome.
I know, right?
Okay, I have one spot left. Let me make it count.
Wait, that was 60. Oh, that's 70. There we go. I'm just gonna quickly move them all.
Oh shite.
Yeah, I mean he was bellowing for something.
But I heard the hyenas coming from this direction.
Yes, there are hyenas in that direction.
Oh great.
Yeah? I know, right? And they have a whooping 100 feet of movement. Well, they have 50 feet, but if they double run...
Oh, right, okay.
They get like... So... Let's see. That one is there.
They're still animals, so...
Yeah, of course they're animals.
I could try to turn them to our side.
Ah, I think that's it. That's all of them. There we go. Just a few hyenas, and the others are all gonna congregate on the food. For now, no, actually, let them sit there. That's it, Oct.
Yay!
Oct sees the bunch of little dogs coming.
About the same size as him.
Yeah, basically.
Oct takes a step here. And then he'll grumble to the Grandmaster, cover your ears, and then he's gonna...
Thunderclap! You create a burst of thunder sound within 100 feet away. That's good, yeah, make everyone available that you are there. Mm-hmm. Everyone who didn't know that.
I figured that was like a... happened already.
Okay, so...
Yeah.
Can be here. Each creature other than you within 5 feet of you must make constitution saving throw. Is that everyone within 100 feet?
Everyone within five.
5 feet.
Oh, everyone within five.
Five
so.
Feet, yeah.
Okay.
Oh
yes.
Yeah. No, yeah, it's 100 feet definitely.
Well, I could have been. I mean,
that's overpowered spell.
That would suck.
He hasn't used that one yet, has he?
He did once on the ship.
Yeah, I think he's used it once.
Okay. One hyena fails, the other one succeeds. Minus five. It is being pushed against the wall. It's whimpering. The other one is like, it's really, really angry.
Guildmaster needs to draw as well.
I know. Maybe his eardrums are going to pop now. He takes 5 points of damage.
Because it's a verbal one, I like to imagine Ogd walked up and just yelled, Fusro da!
Okay.
Or fuck right off.
Yeah, something like that.
No, you wanna toss me one more perception, Togan?
What?
One more perception.
Yes, sir.
I hope to kill you all before 7 PM.
Hey.
No, just kidding. The sounds are coming from that direction and then it goes into a bend. And you definitely hear that there must be some gnoll down there, and you hear a lot of hyenas really happily munching on something.
Right. Okay.
Lovely.
Hogan says, there's definitely some back here as he runs over. Oh my god.
Did you just see them right now?
Hogan, they could use a bit of fire over here.
I think he has his own problems.
Over, a firebolt's going for the pack lore.
Sure.
I'd well, say that hits.
That hits?
Yeah, I think it's pretty guaranteed that hit.
He takes a lot of damage. His entire chest hair just goes up in flames and he howls. And he's really enraged now. He's like, you know what?
How dare you make me clean shaven?
I need to get to this wizard thing. If he could think clearly.
Yeah. Oh, that's it.
Milo?
You're still... No, you're on the ground, right? You don't have your little wings.
Yeah, I'm on the... I never took them off.
Unless you want to go up on the wall again.
No. Milo's going to run up to this first one and with his offhand dagger, stab it.
Sure. Yeah, you just come running forward, just stab it right into the heart, I guess. Unless you want to target something else, because it drops dead.
Nah. Alright, and then I run over its body, and then with the other one, attack it.
Wait, where did you go now?
I just ran one more forward.
Yeah, you were just hiding beneath a carcass, okay. That one hits as well, it's not dead though.
I get sneak attack as well.
Well, I've got that. How do you want to kill it then? Because that sneak attack is very powerful.
Well, hyenas have nice HP.
I just stab it in the face.
That's common knowledge.
You dealt like 5 damage to it, I think.
That was the one you just stabbed. The first one. Yeah, that one was unarmed. Unharmed.
Yeah. That's what I was telling Og. I think the one that I killed with 4 had been hit already. Mm-hmm. And then... I sit there because I can't do anything else.
Yeah, so you basically rush forward and just sink your dagger right into the skull of the hyena and it just pops, goes down to the ground, all paws from it.
And these have fuck all health, huh?
Yeah, it looks like they have like 6 because it has like a little bit more than
I mean, he just dealt 22 points of damage to it, so it could be anything between 6 and 22.
Well, had to be 9 at most, so...
The Peg Lord, he's like, ugh. Let's see, doesn't he? Ugly. I know he gets like multi-attack, I believe. Let me just check that. Oh yeah, he has multi-attack. He has his massive longsword in his hand. And he brings it down against Seldar and he's like, VAM! 7 points of damage. WAM! 10 points of damage.
Ow, what a dick.
Captain Kitchen, no!
So, two attacks, and then he growls, and the hyenas just get more frenzy. Stuff. That was more like a monkey, but you know what I mean. Yeah, Mia.
I'm gonna prepare my last Hail of Thorns, and I'm gonna sharpshoot this fucker.
Okay. Do it.
Maybe don't sharpshoot if you're gonna...
Oh, there we go.
Well, that one, the arrow just shoop impales it. In it and it just dies outright.
For my Hail of Thorns, everything within his area must make a dex save.
Okay, that's just 5 of them. Okay.
Ymir, you have 9 other numbers on that d10.
I know.
It can be more than a 3.
What's that?
You don't have to luck with a d10.
He has to make it 2, doesn't he? The big guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, 3 of them take 3 points of damage.
Exactly, Hail of Thorns only works once, or does also work in the second arrow? I need to read that.
I'm just doing this on them. The others, they just take 1.
Hail of Thorns is 1 per attack.
Good thing I have a second attack then.
There you go. So, yeah, you can shoot once again.
Yeah, I'm gonna shoot at the pack leader.
The big one. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Now he goes to his knees. He's still alive, but definitely kneeling down on one knee.
Yep.
Still no gnolls available, so we continue with Seldarin, who's like, he's like, he looks at all the hyenas and he's like, back up, back up, and he just attacks the gnoll peg lord with his sword, and then he's gonna run the hell out of there. Oh, he kills the gnoll peg lord. He just stabs him through the skull while he is down, but then he just gets the hell out of there. He like walks 30 feet backwards.
There goes our light source.
Are we gonna have
an intermission in this combat because I'm being called for dinner, or
yeah. Well, do you want to leave it here and we can resume it in the middle of the fight next week and then we can do XP like at the end of the dungeon and such rather than just doing it at the end of this week?
Yeah, we can do that. I'm just going to position all the hyenas around.
That one hyena.
I'm gonna run for
they're all running around us.
Yeah, they're surrounding you, so we're going to have that at the beginning of next time.
I'm looking forward to that.
I mean, this is a good dungeon, Doc. This is really Sebastian good. Is going to be here next week, so he might just have to play civilian or something. I don't know.
We can just observe until we get back, because I'm presuming this dungeon won't take too long.
It depends. It's pretty small. Depends.
From the brief glimpse we had of the entire map, there were quite a bit of enemies on the map.
All I remember seeing was a circle.
Right, so I leave it how it is. I'm going to move you all back to there.
Cool.
Close the turn order.
That was fun.
Thank and you much, hope that you don't die next week.
We'll be fine. Cheerio.
Okay, see ya.